Hey guys, welcome back to a new day and a new stream. It's some more Stanley Parable time. I hope you guys are ready because I am very, very, very ready. We're gonna see how many endings we can get this time. I'm very excited to see because I thought the game was done. I thought the game was over, but apparently not even close. So we're gonna see if I can figure out these puzzles. But hi, how are y'all doing? I missed you. We didn't see each other last Friday. Yes, right? We saw each other on Thursday, so it's been a few days. How was all of you guys' weekend? I want to know all about it. Also, let me say hi. Oh, Gassy, you're here. How are you doing, Gassy? How have you been? What were you up to today? Did you have a good day today? I'm guessing you were working today. Am I correct? I'm guessing you were working today. 50k channel points for life, wee woo. I've only got 4k. Hey, don't blame me, okay? Blame Goku. I did exactly what Goku suggested, okay? That's all. That's all I did. This is not my fault. I would have given it for cheaper, but you know, Goku was like, please, can you do this for us for 50k channel points? It's not my fault. I'm so sorry. And Chris, you're here as well. How are you doing, Chris? What were you up to today? What did you do? I hope you had a good day so far. You're at 35k. Excuse me. What are you doing with those points, huh? What are you saving them up for? And Addis, you're here as well. How are you doing, Addis? How was your weekend? What did you do this weekend? And how was your day today? I hope you're doing well. I'm so happy to see you. I hope you're doing good. You guys are here so fast. Oh, Goku! The man himself is here. How are you doing, Goku? How was your weekend? I hope you're doing good. So happy to see you again, Goku. I hope you're doing good. And Woozy is here as well. Hi, Woozy. You're here so fast. How are you doing, Woozy? I hope you're doing well. And Quaggan as well. You guys are here so fast. Jesus Christ. Hi, Quaggan. How are you doing? How was your weekend? What did you do this weekend? A bit of work still to do, and then I'll be heading home. Then I'm only listening, occasionally type something in chat. Hope you all have a great time. Thank you so much, Addis, and good luck with the rest of work. I hope you will smash it. I hope it won't be too much trouble and too much work. I hope you will be done very, very soon, and that you can go home and rest. But yeah, good luck. I'm ready to parable. My name is Stanley. Oh my, oh my, oh my. Lots of Elden Ring. Gosh darn it. Last time I guessed Elden Ring and you did work, and this time I was like, well, let's think about this last time, you know? So I was like, okay, so it's work, not Elden Ring, and it's Elden Ring. Finish your work on Friday. Oh, that's great. So how far are you into it now? Are you still addicted? Thursday and today? Wrong Thursday and today. What did I say? What did I say? Is that not what I said? What are we talking about? What are we talking about? What did I say this time? Oh, you know, literally, you know. Yeah, I do. You're doing good? I am happy to hear that, Goku. I am very, very, very happy to hear that. Did you do anything fun this weekend? Or today? But I'm guessing today was probably just a work day, right? I'm busy. Only 3 weeks left. Time is going so fast. Only 3 weeks left. Jesus Christ. Yeah, I can imagine you're busy then. Ooh, when will it calm down? Is the stream okay for you guys? I hope the stream is okay. But when will it calm down? Only after the 3 weeks? Is it like 3 weeks until you're done with all your exams, or 3 weeks until officially the vacation starts? Stream looks good? Okay, just on my end, it looked a little bit bad. Oh, you're wrong about it, was it? Yeah, I know. I feel like I know you so well, and I apparently know you really badly because I'm wrong all the time. I'm 72 hours in. Someone has been playing a teeny tiny bit, I see. Just beat a big boss 10 minutes ago. I was in a rush to get to the stream. Nice. Congrats on beating the big boss, whatever that may have been. Congrats. I'm so happy to hear that. 3 weeks until I'm done with almost all my exams. Okay. So 3 weeks to go. That's not too much at all. You can do it. Only 3 more weeks and then vacation. Long, long vacation time. Think about all the Guild Wars that you're going to be able to play. By the way, guys, apparently, almost all of you knew about this, at least the people that checked the spoiler chat. On Saturday, I was visiting Chris and Andrew, right, in England. And they had some presents for me. They gave me some RAM, which is mind-blowing and freaking amazing. I'm still struggling a little bit with making it work. Just some problems on my end. Anyway, freaking amazing. We're already some rammed up right now. I just need to make the last one work. But we're better already, guys. We're better already. We're improving. All thanks to Chris and Andrew. But besides that, they also gave me something else, which most of you guys saw in the spoiler chat, I think. Da-da-da-da. Look at that. Would you look at that? Isn't that stunning? I have tea in there, so I'm trying not to spill it while turning it around. Isn't that the most amazing thing you have ever seen in your life? I mean, for me it is, and there's no wrong answer, but there is a right answer, and that's yes. This is the best thing you've ever seen in your life. That's basically the only answer, guys. Come on. I want to hear nothing else besides yes, because come on. They made this for me. They made this for me. That makes me feel really emotional, but yeah. I'm so happy with it. I think it's freaking amazing. That's so pretty. I know, right? I know. That is by far one of the most amazing things that has ever happened to me. So, yeah. I'm very, very, very happy with it. Hope everyone's doing well. Me too, Lizzie. Me too. I hope you're doing well too. I must admit, I summoned a ton for it. It felt lore appropriate though. Yeah. That's a good excuse you're trying to pull there, Gasly. That's a good excuse you're trying to pull there. I see how it is. You cheater. You little cheater. How did it feel, huh? I thought you didn't summon either. How did it feel to do this? Do we have some music happening? A bit soft, right? Is it? Turn it up a little bit. That's so pretty, that's so amazing. I know, guys, isn't it? I know. You guys have no clue how happy I am with it. It stands here on my desk very proudly. Very proudly. You're gonna make me cry. That's what I am saying, okay? That's what I'm saying. You're making me cry. I got the boss at like 20% health on my first try, so in my mind, I could have beaten him by myself. Fair enough. Cheater. Fair enough, cheater. Fair enough. Also today, guys, I've been working a little bit on the TwitchCon program. So it's becoming more and more certain that for TwitchCon, well, Chris is coming, Gems is coming, and Kimmy. So that's three people that will be coming here. They will even be staying at my house. So it's going to be one big party. And it's really exciting. I've been working a little bit on a planning, see if I can keep everyone entertained, that we can do fun things. We're gonna go on a boat tour. We're gonna go do mini golf in glow-in-the-dark mini golf. We're gonna go visit museums, the arcade, TwitchCon, obviously. Gonna do some fun drinking games. We're gonna do all the fun things, guys. So I'm really, really, really excited. Like, making the schedule today made me just, I want to scream for excitement that everyone's coming, so. Sorry. You actually did it, now I need to do my part? Yeah, I did it. Were you not listening, Goku? Were you not listening? I was talking about you. Why do you have so many points? Are you kidding me? I thought we would never get there. I thought this was a joke. I thought this was a joke. I thought, nah. No way. No one will ever get there. That's 50k points. That's not gonna happen. No way, no how. Where did you pull that out of? Are you cheating? Are you gambling points? What's happening, Goku? Where did you get them? I don't want them. I don't want to do a live wee-woo. Oh my god, first stream after I put it in? I don't wanna. Goku, what are you doing to me? What are you doing to me, Goku? Why is this a thing? No! No, you don't, Goku! No, you don't! Do you? I gotta take that thing out again. This was a mistake. I gotta take that thing out again. This was such a big mistake. You don't? Okay, thank God. Okay. You guys ready? It's once and probably never again, okay? Once and probably never again. I'll try to do the whole thing, okay? Soon I will. Okay. Nervous now. Why am I nervous? Well, I know because it's freaking embarrassing, but I'm nervous now. You guys got me nervous. I'm ready. I will bring the camera. No, Mom, please. That's embarrassing, Mom. Don't do it. Wee woo, wee woo, wee woo, wee woo. Please open up. There you go. Okay, I want to die now. Thank you. I want to die now. Thank you. I did not enjoy that. Oh my god. I don't even know why I ever started this. Why would I ever embarrass myself like this? Why did I ever start this? Such a big mistake. I don't know what goes on in my mind sometimes, guys, but it's nothing good. Nothing good goes on in my mind. I tell you, it's a big, big old mess up here, okay? Jesus Christ. That was brilliant, thank you. Once and never again, guys, okay? Once and never again. I hope everyone was there for it, because it will not happen again. Considering things. Chris! 7 whole months of Chesh! Thank you so much, Chris. That's so sweet. Thank you so much for the sub. I really appreciate it. 7 whole months. How have you been surviving for that long with me, Chris? Not only online, but now in real life as well? You poor, poor guy. You must not have many brain cells, do you? I feel so sorry for you. It must be a tough life for you right now. Exposure therapy, clearly. Does that mean we're slowly ramping it up? Huh? Does that mean that soon it's gotta be more and more and more and more of Myrta? Huh? Is that how it's gonna be? You gotta use it now? Aww. No more exposure therapy, I guess. Hi, Peter. How are you doing? I'm so happy to see you, Peter. How was your weekend? And how are you in general? And you just missed something great, just heard open up. I opened up and I closed right back down. And this is gonna stay locked and the key is gone and that will never ever happen again. Mikes! You're here as well, Mikes! How are you doing? How have you been, Mikes? I hope you're doing okay. Today's episode of Streamer Play themselves, chat emerges victorious as usual. Feel like I never win. How is that possible? I feel like I never win. I don't feel like that's how it should be. I don't feel like that's how it should be at all. Right? Shouldn't the streamer win from the viewers? No? Am I confused here? That was a good clip? What was a good clip? Soon I'm spending more than a single day with you, so yeah, that's gonna be so scary. What happened with the lights? What was that? Why did the lights flash? That's strange. But yeah, I feel so sorry for you, Chris. That's gonna be intense. I hope you brought like some anti-Myrta medicine, maybe. I hope you're mentally prepping yourself. Start off the day with some yoga and some meditation, maybe. That might help you be able to, because it's 3 days, okay? It's 3 whole days you gotta spend with me in a row. Saturday, Sunday, and Monday. 3 whole days you're going to spend with me in one row. So, I mean, you better mentally prep for that, okay? Please. Just over 30 days. Yes, TwitchCon is coming so close. It's getting so close. It's getting so close. Yes, we're talking TwitchCon, Kimmy. Also, hi. How are you doing? I hope you're doing good, Kimmy. We are very, very much talking TwitchCon, which Kimmy is very likely coming to as well, guys, like I just said. And now that we're on the topic of TwitchCon anyway, is there anyone else by any chance here in chat that's like, well, I wasn't planning on going, but now that I hear all the fun things that Chesh has planned, I am actually considering going as well. Gassy, Mike, Peter, Goku, everyone else here. Maybe? Anyone else that considers going? Maybe? Huh? I was just throwing it out there. I'm just throwing it out there. That's all. You know, no pressure, but so much pressure. Okay, guys, so much pressure. Okay. If there's any more tickets rolling out, I mean, there are tickets still rolling out, but not for the one day. But all the fun things I've planned are not for TwitchCon anyway. They're for the days after TwitchCon, right? And around TwitchCon, so... Delight detected the wee. You made a moment of the wee. Wait, did you? No, you did not. You wouldn't do that. You wouldn't do that, Ghastly. Mods are on my side. You would never do that. You're a good mod. You're a kind mod. Right? Don't prove me wrong there. You're a kind mod. I know you are. I want to hear none of those jokes. Those jokes are not funny, okay? I'm not bad, thanks, how are you? I'm so happy to hear that, Mike. I'm doing pretty good, too. Had a pretty fun day today, actually. Gassy moment of the wee. No, you guys are just making one big joke together, right? You guys are just making one big joke together, no. Not funny. Not funny. Okay, now, see, Peter's in on it, too. I see what's going on. You guys are just talking in between amongst yourselves again, you know, making it into one big funny joke. Very funny. I sadly did not win the lottery, so no TwitchCon for me. But you don't need a TwitchCon ticket to have fun with me, huh? You just need a ticket to get here, which might be a lot for you. How about this? Stream it and me and Gassy can hang out in chat. Technically, we went to. But for you, it's so easy to get here, Mikes. It's so easy to get here. And then you'll see Gems as well. And you'll see Kimmy and Chris. But who wants to see that? No. Sorry, Chris. And me, you know, most importantly. No. None of your mods are on your side. That's not true. Cheshbot is always on my side, I feel, right? Isn't Cheshbot always on my side, guys? We definitely don't have a moment. The damage has been done. No, I don't want to believe it. I am very much refusing to believe that, okay? I'm just not believing that. It's just not a thing. It's just not a thing. You like that idea, Mikes? Ah, I don't like that at all, Mikes. I don't like that at all. You have stupid ideas, okay? You have stupid, stupid ideas. I want to, but still no idea how my military training will go and if I will be able to get days off. Yeah, no, I completely get that. Sorry, guys. My throat still hurts a little bit. But, yeah, no, you have a good excuse, Addis. You are the only one here that is off the hook for me. You are the only one here that has an excuse for me, which is also why I didn't name you, because I know you actually have a good reason for not going. Mike's, however, no good reason. Goku, no good reason. What's your reason, Goku? Why are you not coming, huh? You live pretty close by, too. You have no good excuse. No good excuse. I mean, what is happening here, guys? Are you guys trying to tell me in some weird roundabout way that you actually don't like me? And that you don't actually want to hang out with me? Is that what you're trying to tell me? Because that's the message that I'm slowly starting to get, okay? And I don't like that message. I don't like that message one bit. I want you guys to change the narrative and make me think that's not the message and actually come and visit me, okay? Please. Australia needs his own Twitch card. Yeah, but I won't be able to get there. I won't be able to get there. You don't need a TwitchCon ticket to have fun with me. Yeah, I stand behind that. That sounds a little bit wrong, though. I don't know why, but it sounds a little bit wrong. By the way, I said if TwitchCon rolls out more one day tickets, I will be going to TwitchCon. Yeah, no, of course. I completely get that. I mean, that's what I was waiting for too. I mean, I didn't know it was an option. To be honest, I was just debating if I should buy the 2-day ticket or just not go. But then suddenly they roll out more 1-day tickets. Thank God. But yeah. So we can finally see a big live collaboration stream with Jemima, Kimmy, and Chris. Yeah. All the biggest streamers out there, guys. The best streamers out there. The most fun streamers out there. All together. In real life. In one room. I don't think you guys would be able to handle that stream, okay? I don't think you guys would be able to handle that stream. I need to take a sip, by the way. Let me turn it around! By the way, what I also have today... Wait, let me take a sip first. There we go. What I also have for today is some nice cider, guys. With... I'll take a sip of this one as well. With some ice. So I'm going from hot to cold. There you go. Rot? Huh? What? Aslan Zuko stream? Yeah, that will be a thing too, guys. I'm so curious to see how that's gonna go. I went to the beach on Sunday. And Zuko met another corgi there. And they played together so nicely. It was so freaking sweet to see. They kept chasing each other all along the beach and through the water and everything. Oh, so cute. So cute. Mirta literally took my voice away on Saturday. That's true. You guys should have heard the guy. He straight went back into puberty. It was great. I loved it. Being on the other side of the world, not a good enough excuse. No, it's not. Not when I offer to pay for your ticket. Otherwise, good excuse. Now, not so much. I could maybe afford a boat ride to Estonia and I could steal a rowboat there and row to the Netherlands. Yeah, Peter, why are you not doing that? Where's the dedication, huh? Where's the dedication to meeting me in real life? I feel disappointed in you, Peter. I'm not mad. I'm just disappointed. That's all, okay? I'm just disappointed. I'm here in chat, so technically I already came to visit you. Nah. Nice try, Mikes. Absolutely not. That does not count, okay? Nice try. I was gonna steal a boat and roll my way to the Netherlands. Hopefully that magic happens to me. You got the mug? I did, Kimmy. I did. Look at that. Isn't it the best thing ever? It's my own personal mug. What I saw later, guys, I don't know if you guys can see it. Yeah, you can see it. Look, it's their logos. Whoops. It's their logos. I don't think you can see it well enough. Actually, maybe. Isn't that nice? Hidden in there, I think it looks great. I like it so much. That mug is actually a decent size. Oh yeah, it is. Oh yeah. Look at that. I'll take another sip. There we go. Do you see that? It'll be 28 degrees on Friday. I know. 28 degrees on Friday and then 27 on Saturday. And then Sunday, the day that I'm going to the festival and I will be outside all day, it's going to be 19 degrees, which is perfect, but also rain the whole day, which is less perfect. So... Quite unlucky in that regard, unfortunately. You didn't have to describe it like that, accurate though. I know I didn't have to. But also, you know, I wanted to, so. Did you have a twin microphone with a jack output if we need microphones? Oh God. Are we actually doing this? Please, for the love of God. Don't scare me like that. You guys don't want to see this in real life stream, okay? Actually, I changed my mind. All of you guys should not come to visit because you don't want to see this in real life either. Never mind. Stay in your continent. Stay in your country. Don't cross any borders. Don't rowboat over here. Don't come to see me, okay? Don't come visit. Had to put a tiny little signature. Yeah, I like it. I like it a lot. I love finding that little... Feels like I found like a little Easter egg, you know, basically. I'll bring it just in case. Yeah. Good choice, Kimmy. Good choice. Bring it and then we'll never use it. Okay? How about that? Now, guys. Should we actually go play the game? Should we?
I don't know.
Let's see. I opened the game, guys. And I got this, which I did not get before.
Be it, you know.
Oh, right. Thank you so much for the follow. I really appreciate it. Welcome to the stream. Thank you so much. Play games? Don't worry, Thomas. I'm just kidding. I'm just joking around here. I'm just joshing you all. You know, where does that saying even come from? Joshing you. I'm just joshing you. Is it like the name Josh? Like I'm just joshing you? Was there just one guy that was just constantly being so funny and making jokes and pulling people's legs? And so people started constantly saying like, oh, I'm just joshing you, you know? And then slowly it went around the world. And now everyone's just saying, I'm just joshing you. Maybe? I don't know. I think it's time to come clean. This was the stream. I hit exactly 50K. Now I'm back to 150 points. I mean, that does not surprise me, because how on earth would it be possible that you had more than 50K? I don't even know how it's possible you have 50K. And you spend your points as well sometimes. Unlike the pull the levers and the no peeking and stuff. I don't even understand. I don't even understand how that's possible. Let's game? I don't know, guys. I kind of think that that's too out of our comfort zone here. We shouldn't go too crazy, you know? We shouldn't do too many weird things here on the stream. We should keep it as we usually do, which is just chatting, you know? Could be fun if you guys could stream something while there. I'll talk to them about it, see if they're up for something. I mean, for sure, we gotta play some games, right? You guys can see that. Are you allowed to stream TwitchCon? Probably, right? Probably every streamer is going to walk around there with a camera like this, right? Right? Streaming to your audience? No? I got to go back to my game then. Have fun with the Stanley Parable. Thank you so much, Kimmy. I really appreciate it. And thank you for stopping by. That's so sweet of you. Have fun with your game. I hope you'll have a great time. It's going to take me some time before I redeem it again. Okay, thank God. Then I don't have to take it away. Then I can leave it for now and take it away just before you hit that 50K. How about that? Wouldn't that be smart? Wouldn't that be smart? You can stream TwitchCon? Yeah, that doesn't surprise me. Damn it, Josh. Stop joshing around, Josh. Just don't go to the bathroom with the camera if you know, you know. I do not know, but also don't go to the bathroom while having the microphone still on. That seems like something that would more easily happen, no? Oh, I got some yellow lights now. Wheezy, that's nice. I had almost 80K during the 12-hour stream. I spent over 35K. Yeah, I spent a lot during one of Jemima's streams as well. I think it might also have been a 12-hour stream. Yeah, I think it was a 12-hour stream. Now I'm back to like 40K for Jemsa's streams again. I guess before your Twitch time? Yeah, I have not been twitching for that long. I've not been streaming for that long yet. You don't regret anything? Oh, you like to see me suffer, huh? Is that it? You like to see me suffer. I see how it is, Goku. I see how it is. So yeah, I started the game, guys. And I had to say what time it is. So it's 5:32. Oh, no, wait. We did do this before, didn't we? Make it 33 and we switch it at the 33 mark. I had the most delicious cider in England while visiting them, by the way, guys. So freaking good. Their ciders there. Ah, top notch, top notch. You said the time last time. Yeah, see, I figured suddenly. I figured I did. I just forgotten. It's on 5 a.m. now? Yeah, but it only... Oh, a.m. Yeah, you're right. My bad. You're right. There we go. 5 p.m. Thank you. Thank you for noticing, Quaggan. I did not see that. Thanks. Hang on. Before we get started, can I just say something? Thank you for actually setting the clock both times you've booted up the game. A lot of people don't take that step seriously. They just leave the clock set at 12 and call it a day. But you're actually taking the time to set the clock, and I appreciate that. That's how I know you care about this experience. You're paying attention. I don't even have any way of knowing if the times you're setting are correct. Tell you what, I'll make you a deal. Since you've been so cooperative, next time you boot up the game and see the screen, just set the clock to your favorite time. Go ahead, pick whichever time you want. Even if it's not the correct time, you've earned it. Alright, I'll let you get back to the video game now. Interesting! Okay. That's nice. The end is never the end, is never the end, is never the end, is never the end, guys. Saturday High was actually the Swedish
this
company?
This is a story of a Copenberg, man named
really?
Stan.
Yeah, we can skip this. I want to look for that cider. Oh, achievement unlocked. Welcome back. Nice. I want to look for that cider now in the Netherlands because that was so good.
All of his co-workers were gone. What could it mean?
Let's see.
Stanley decided to go to the meeting room. Perhaps he had simply missed a memo.
We did the new content.
When Stanley came to a set of two
and
open
then we
doors,
gotta go this
was not
way,
the correct
right?
way to the meeting room, and Stanley knew it perfectly well. Perhaps he wanted to stop by the employee lounge first, just to admire it.
Now let's see what else we can do here. There was gonna be something with a telephone, which is one
yes,
option.
Yes, truly a room worth admiring. It had really been but eager to get back to business, Stanley took the first open door on his left.
Was that the phone? We didn't even take that one either, did we? But we're gonna skip it for now.
Stanley was so bad at following directions, it's incredible he wasn't 5 years ago. Look, Stanley, I think perhaps we've gotten off on the wrong foot here. I'm not your enemy, really, I'm not. I realize that investing your trust in someone else can be difficult, but the fact is that the story has been about nothing but you all this time. There's someone you've been neglecting, Stanley.
Can get off here.
Someone you forgot.
What? Really? I was in the middle of something. Do you have zero consideration for others? Are you that convinced that I want something bad to happen to you? Well, I don't know how to convince you of this, but I really do want to help you, to show you something beautiful.
Look, danger. Danger
it.
Everywhere.
Let me prove that I'm on your side. Give me a chance.
How do we give him a chance? There's probably multiple endings in something like this as well, I have a feeling. Oh,
now listen
see?
Carefully, this is important. Stanley walked through the red door.
Nope.
Aha, perhaps you misunderstood. Stanley walked through the red door. I still don't think we're communicating properly. Stanley walked through the red door. All right, fine. Go ahead, Stanley. You want to know so badly what's out there? You want to find out what lies at the end of this road you've chosen? Well, don't let me stop you. You see?
Oh.
There's nothing here. I haven't even finished building this section of the map because you were never supposed to be here in the first place. Broken rooms, exposed developer textures. Is this what you had wanted? Was it worth ruining the entire story I had written out specifically for you? Do not think I put a lot of time into that, because I did. And in the end, it was all for nothing, because this is what you wanted to see. Help me here, Stanley. Help elucidate these strange and unknowable desires of yours. What would have made this game better? What did you want to see? Vehicles? Skill trees? Work with me. You give me absolutely nothing so far. Tell you what. Let me take a stab in the dark at a new design, and you can give me some feedback.
Ooh!
There we go. A third option. This already feels leaps ahead of where we were before. Go ahead, Stanley. Take it for a spin.
This is still not finished, right? Look, these textures weren't there before.
Okay, I'm going to stop you there. Now, tell me about your experience with this new version. Would you say that the game benefited from allowing you more choices? Feel free to be honest. I'm looking for some real critical feedback here.
Yes, I already found it better.
Okay, so we're getting somewhere. Clearly there's something here that speaks to you. If I can be honest here, I really don't have any idea where I'm going with this. This whole third door thing was just a stab in the dark. But I guess you're into it, so let's keep this party train rolling. Here, based on the data from your previous playthrough, I've compiled a new version. And to be perfectly candid, I think I've knocked it out of the park with this one. Let's take a look.
The Stanley Parable Worldwide Leaderboard. What? Oh, wow. Look at that. Huh. You know that 21.3% of players skipped the intro sequence. Only the worst 3% of players choose the blue door. Stanley. How long does it take you to get to the correct door? Compete against others to improve your Stanley Parable career. You are objectively ranked with the worst one. This is you. We're the worst one. A dead rat. Even a dead rat is better than us. Oh my god. Okay. Now let's go through this door again.
Now, would you say that competitive leaderboard helped you feel motivated to keep walking through doors? Again,
yeah,
honest
for
answers,
sure.
Please. Hey, I nearly forgot. I've got a prototype of a new game I've been working on, and now would be a lovely opportunity to give it some playtesting. You wouldn't mind taking a look at it, would you? Perfect. Let me boot it up. In this game, the baby crawls left towards danger. You click the button to move him back to the right, and if he reaches the fire, you fail. It's a very meaningful game. All about the desperation and tedium of endlessly confronting the demands of
family life. We're not
gonna save
the baby, are we?
I think the art world will really take notice. But of course, the message of the game only becomes clear once you've been playing it for about 4 hours. So why don't you give it 4 hours of play to make sure it's effective? Be sure to keep notes on your experience. You heartless bastard. Did you do it because you hate babies or purely to spite me? Because if it's the latter, well, I don't know what to do. I'm completely out of ideas. I can't think of a single thing that might improve the experience for me. I'm not even going to try. I'm out. I'm done. It's over. Thank you for playing. Your input was extremely valuable. Oh, hey, since my game was so awful, why don't we play someone else's game? Just to ease the pain. Let's see. What do we have here? Yes, this seems like it'll work. Let's give it a shot.
Minecraft. Oh!
Aha! Fascinating. What do you think this game is about, Stanley? What's our backstory? What is our motivation? Well, it seems obvious to me that you are meant to play as a creepy man spying on innocent civilians below you from up high in your creep tower, perhaps for some sort of twisted erotic Yes, that must be it. What a fascinating venture into the experience of total mental depravity. So far, I love everything about this game, Stanley. And it seems there's even more. Come, let's venture outward and see what else is out there.
Yeah, what if I don't move? Give it a few seconds. Phoenix! Hi! How are you doing? I'm so happy to see you. How are you? How have you been? I hope you're doing good. Not even one push? No. What if only one push already moves it back, huh? We're so similar, I didn't even hesitate to let it die! Me siblings, right? Runs in the family. Just pure evil. You were so surprised when you saw this. I love this. This is great. What does it actually say? Don't tread on me. Makes sense. Wow, this is so... Is it from the same people? Firewoods? Yeah, I know. Did the same people make this game? In a non-deluxe edition, the game actually was Minecraft. Wait, really? Honestly? That's really funny. I need a creep tower! Please, please tell me it's not a neurotic creep tower. Wow, what the frig? We're suddenly in Firewatch, that's so strange.
No, it can't be.
Too open.
What do you know?
It is. It's an open world game. Good God, quickly, block it off.
Oh! Ah! Oh. No!
Thank goodness, Stanley, what a close call. You nearly wandered off into that thing. That big, open, just wandering around. No right or wrong directions. No path to follow. You can just go in any... Oh, thank heavens we avoided it. We're out of the woods now, Stanley. Okay, I'm going to get us out of here. Let's find another game. Preferably something with walls. Something with nice, big, insurmountable walls.
I wonder what we're going to play now.
Okay, I think this will be just the thing.
Oh? Is this Rocket League?
Wonderful. See, this is exactly what I had in mind.
It is Rocket League!
Just a nice big box for you to run around in. There isn't any possibility that you could get lost here. Now this is game design. Stanley, if you manage to get lost in this game, I will be phenomenally impressed.
The frig!
Okay, so what exactly do we do here? Let's see. There are lots of cars here in the back, but obviously there's no racetrack. Okay, I'm seeing that there's a ball of some kind back here. Is this game sports ball? Stanley, I think it's sports ball. Oh, what fun. We shall run the bases and do a touchdown together. Yes, I think surely we must. Okay, Stanley, here's the ball. Have fun.
Oh my God. We're moving faster now. Not fast enough, though.
Are you doing it? Are you winning? Is this fun? Is it better than my miserable little story that I worked so hard on? Stanley, I have a thought.
I know!
And I realize I'm not a sportsologist, but if one ball generates a certain amount of raw adrenal pleasure, then surely multiple balls makes for an even more euphoric sports experience. I'm going to try it out. Here comes another ball.
Oh, no.
Yes.
Oh, we're moving a lot
really
faster now.
It does feel amazing, doesn't it? Stanley, I'm like a child in a confectionery shop. I simply have to have more. I'm insatiable.
Oh, no. No, 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 no. No, 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 no. Oh, God. That's a lot of balls. That's a lot of balls.
Are you enjoying this, Stanley? Are you having fun? Is this a real video game? Well, I sure hope you're having a good time, because guess what? It's over. That's right. Your little fun comes to an end. This is my game, and what I say goes. You get to have fun when I let you, Stanley. Besides, you need someone like me to set boundaries for you. Without rules or boundaries, video games are nothing. Yes, that's what I am. I'm structure. I'm your sense of purpose. And since you decided you didn't want to play my game, now I don't want to play with you either. So, goodbye, Stanley. I'm leaving. See how you'd like it when I'm not around to set the rules. Somehow, I don't think you'll enjoy it as much. But who knows? You're an inventive kid. You'll come up with something. After all, you're the one who knows best. Take care, Stanley.
Is that just it now? Now what? No more balls either? We're still fast, though. Noted just asked the Firewatch devs if they could use their game, and they said yes. Oh, that's awesome. I really love that. So probably the game with Rocket League then, right?
Hold on. Oh! What are you doing? Stanley, don't do that. I can't follow you there. I can't help you. How will you write a story without me? You can't do it. You know that. Stanley, come back.
Now what? Oh! Didn't mean to do that. Oh! Now where are we? Oh God, we're gonna get so lost here. Oh God. Oh God, this just goes on forever, doesn't it? Door? Yeah. Dead end. Oh god! Actually, that's pretty helpful, Mikes. That's pretty helpful. I can see the game a bit better now. Thank you. That's great. Oh, there we go. That's probably where we need to be. Great to see this. I throw myself in a void. You mean the one I just jumped into? Is that it? Excuse me. Is this where he spies on us? Now what? Nothing here. What?
I wonder what he found. If what he wanted was to be the leading man in his own story, well, perhaps he's gotten it. Down in wherever he is right now. I wonder if he's happy with his choice, and if he's learned the heavy cost that comes with it. He'll understand soon what I was trying to tell him. He needs me. Someone who will wrap everything up at the end, to make sense out of the chaos and the fear and the confusion. That's who I am. That is what I mean to this world. Oh, yes. Yes, I'll be back. There's no other way. Once this ends, after it all comes to a close, then I'll be back. The end will be here soon. Very soon.
Yeah, but the end is never the end, the end is never the end. Excuse me. Oh! There we go. Okay, let's do that again, I guess.
All his co-workers were gone. What could it mean? Stanley decided to go to the meeting room. Perhaps he had simply missed a memo.
Let's see.
When now we Stanley gotta go left came again. To a set of two open... This was not the correct way to the meeting room, and Stanley knew it perfectly well. Perhaps he wanted to stop by the employee lounge first, just to admire it. Wow. Yes. This room... But eager to get back to business, Stanley took the first open door on his left.
Nope, still not. We're gonna jump down again.
Stanley was so bad at following directions, it's incredible he wasn't 5 years ago. Look, Stanley, I think perhaps
okay, this time we're gonna make sure the baby doesn't catch on fire.
I'm not your enemy, really, I'm not.
See what
happens
then.
I realize investing your trust in someone else can be difficult, but the fact is that the story has been about nothing but you all this time.
I guess we could also jump all the way off here.
Someone you've forgotten?
What? Really? I was in the middle of something. Do you have zero consideration for others? Are you that convinced that I want something bad to happen to you? Why, I don't know how to convince you of this, but I really do want to help you, to show you something beautiful. Look, let me prove it. Let me prove that I'm on your side. Give me a chance.
We're gonna save the baby this time.
Stanley walked through the red door.
And then after that, we gotta walk through the red door,
perhaps
obviously.
You misunderstood. Stanley walked through the red door. I still don't think we're communicating properly. All right, fine. Go ahead, Stanley. You want to know so badly what's out there? You want to find out what lies at the end of this road you've chosen? Well, don't let me stop you. You see?
There you go.
There's nothing here. I haven't even finished building this section of the map because you were never supposed to be here in the first place. Broken rooms, exposed developer textures. Is this what you had wanted? Was it worth ruining the entire story I had written out specifically for you? Do you not think I put a lot of time into that? Because I did. And in the end, it was all for nothing. Because this is what you wanted to see. Help me here, Stanley. Help elucidate these strange and unknowable desires of yours. What would have made this game better? What did you want to see? Vehicles? Skill trees? Work with me. You've given me absolutely nothing so
skill
far.
Skill trees would have been fun.
Tell you what. Let me take a stab in the dark at a new design, and you can give me some feedback. There we go. A third option. This already feels leaps
ahead. What if we now don't
we
go through
before.
That?
Go ahead, Stanley. Take it for a spin.
Kind of want to see. Oh!
Okay, I'm going to stop you there.
We get
now,
there either way.
Tell me about your experience with this new version. Would you say that the game benefited from allowing you more choices?
Give it a one this
Feel
time.
Feel free to be honest. I'm looking for some real critical feedback here. A one? I mean, I can understand if you had reservations, you saw ways the game could be improved to more fully express itself mechanically and artistically, but a one? That's not even helpful. What am I supposed to do with that? But I guess it isn't my place to judge. Here, based on the data from your previous playthrough, I've compiled a new version. And to be perfectly candid, I think I've knocked it out of the park with this one. Let's take a look.
Okay, we have the leaderboard now. Let's take the left one and see if that takes us anywhere. Same space
now,
again.
Would you say that competitive leaderboard helped you feel motivated to
keep
walking
through doors? We're
gonna give it a one again. Honest answers, please. Hey, I nearly forgot. I've got a prototype of a new game I've been working on, and now would be a lovely opportunity to give it some playtesting. You wouldn't mind taking a look at it, would you? Perfect. Let me boot it up. In this game, the baby crawls left towards danger. You click the button to move him back to the right, and if he reaches the fire, you fail. It's a very meaningful game, all about the desperation and tedium of endlessly confronting the demands of family life. I think the art world will really take notice. But of course, the message of the game only becomes clear once you've been playing it for about 4 hours. So why don't you give it 4 hours of play to make sure it's effective? Be sure to keep notes on your experience.
Oh my god, that sound is awful. Don't tell me we gotta do this for 4 hours. God, this is awful. Both sounds are awful. Is this not an ending too? Do we gotta do this for 4 hours? Do we only get an ending then? Oh my god, both baby crying and this sound? Something must happen, right? Right? Is nothing gonna happen? It's an ending after 4 hours? I'm not gonna do this for 4 hours. Yeah, I can see this, guys. This is a thing. This is a beat, you know? New song? I like it. I like it. That's exactly what you have to do. Please, your bets, how long will she last? With this sound? Not long? Right, Jen, get settled. I mean, you guys are always asking for us to spend more time together, right? For longer streams? So isn't this what you wanted? Isn't this exactly what you wanted? More time together, more stream time? More gameplay? You guys must be so happy right now. You must be in seventh heaven. I'm just listening to all the feedback. And I'm implementing it all. More gameplay? Longer streams? Nice sound effects? I mean, you didn't ask for that, but that's just free. I'm just giving that to you guys for free. Isn't this great? Okay, that baby's gonna die. Die, baby, die!
You bastard. Did you do it because you hate babies or purely to spite me? Because if it's the latter, well, I don't know what to do. I'm completely out of ideas. I can't think of a single thing that might
baby
improve
died.
Experience for me.
Baby died! Baby did not stay alive!
It's over. Thank you for playing.
Baby did not stay alive!
Oh, hey, since my game was so awful, why don't we play someone else's game? Just to ease the pain. Let's see. What do we have here?
That was great, Gosley. Thank you.
Yes. Seems like it'll work. Let's give it a shot.
Ooh, some firewatch again. There we go.
Aha! Fascinating.
Even
what
the music
do you
think and everything.
What is about, Stanley? What's our backstory? What is our motivation?
Like, everything is
but
just the same.
But it seems obvious to me that you are meant to play as a creepy
which
man
is great.
Spying on innocent civilians
I wonder if
below
they change anything
you from
at
up
all.
High in your creep tower. Perhaps
that's
for some
was
sort
also
of
there
twisted,
well,
erotic
right?
purpose.
I think?
Yes, that must be
was it.
Was it? What a fascinating venture into the experience of total mental depravity. So far, I love everything about this game, Stanley. and it seems there's even more. Come, let's venture outward and see what else is out there.
Firewatch is to Firewatch. Who Firewatches to Firewatch? Good question. Good question. 12-hour stream of this? Is that not what you wanted, Peter? Is that not what you wanted?
Oh, no. No, it can't be.
24-hour? You guys are always asking for a 24-hour stream, huh? How about that?
It is. It's an open 24
hours
game.
Of the baby.
Good God, quickly, block it off.
Yeah.
Oh, thank goodness, Stanley. What a close call.
There are openings, but just not big enough for us to get
thing,
through.
That big, open, just wandering around, no right or wrong directions, no path to follow. You can just go in any... Oh, thank heavens we avoided it.
Look at that. Look at all that content.
Okay, I'm going to get us out of here. Let's find another game. Preferably something with walls. Something with nice, big, insurmountable walls. Okay.
I wonder what the conversation was when it was Minecraft still? In the previous game?
Wonderful.
There you go.
This is exactly what I had in mind. Just a nice big box for you to run around in. There isn't any possibility that you could get lost here. Now,
I wonder
this is game
what
design.
He would have done.
Stanley, if you manage to
after
get lost
he
in
leaves,
this game, I will be phenomenally
if we don't
impressed.
Do anything then. Because now we, of course, jumped into one of these holes.
Okay, so what exactly do we do here? Let's see. There are lots of cars here in the back, but obviously there's no racetrack. Okay, I'm seeing that there's a ball of some kind back here. Is this game sports ball?
Sports.
Stanley, I think it's sports
I
ball.
Love his voice, by the way. His voice
we
acting in
general.
We should run
the bases and
great.
Do a touchdown together.
Yeah, Rocket League?
I
yes, Goku, Rocket League.
Okay, Stanley, here's the ball. Have fun.
Nope. See you later.
What are you doing?
Stanley, don't do that. I can't follow you there. I can't help you.
Here we go. Now where do we need to go again? We can also try this way. I don't think we tried this way yet. Oh, never mind. Let's see. I think it was this direction. And all the way straight. Here, yeah. There it is. But maybe they just let you walk forever? Up until a certain time passes? I don't know if it was triggered by us going into the right room or enough time passing. I made another moment, but the timing isn't so great. Can you still change it? Can you change the moment itself? Because I think you have some playroom, right? Oh, there we go. Okay, so it is triggered at the same moment.
I wonder what he found.
Sorry that we have to go.
What he wanted was to be the leading man in his own story.
Through it again, guys. But I'm not going
to
do 4 hours of the baby for now.
Wherever he is.
Maybe one day.
I wonder if he's happy with his choice. And if he's learned the heavy cost that comes with it. He'll understand soon what I was trying to tell him. He needs me. Someone who will wrap everything up at the end to make sense out of the chaos and the fear and the confusion. That's who I am. That is what I mean to this world. Oh, yes. Yes, I'll be back. There's no other way. Once this ends, after it all comes to a close, then I'll be back. The end
I'll
will be
back.
Here soon. Very soon. I can wait.
I've never been able to find a way to edit the moments. Wait, really? Am I just imagining that? I thought it was just like a clip where you can kind of change. Like, you can't change it forever, but kind of slide it around? Okay, so this time we're going to do the
all
same thing again.
All his coworkers were gone. What could it mean?
Stanley and go through the red door.
The
door.
Room.
See if that
perhaps
changed
he had
anything.
Simply missed a memo.
I hope it does, because otherwise we're just playing through the same thing again. Let's see.
When Stanley came to a set of two open doors, this was not the correct way to the meeting room, and Stanley knew it perfectly well.
Yeah.
He wanted to stop by the employee.
I keep trying to run, but we can't
just
even.
To admire it.
We should go play baby game for 12 hours.
A work of art. But eager
I mean,
to
you never know.
Business,
maybe it will keep
Stanley
going
took
forever.
The first open door on his left.
That's true. You can
Stanley
slightly change
so
the timing. Yeah, you can, right?
It's incredible.
Not like
a lot,
but just like
ago.
A clip that you can kind of slide around.
Look, Stanley, I think
I also want to jump
off
all
the
way
here
and see
sure
if anything happens
really,
then.
I'm not.
Should we just do that now?
Investing your trust in someone else can, but in his eagerness to prove that he is in control of the story and no one gets to tell him what to do, Stanley leapt from the platform and plunged to his death. Good job, Stanley. Everyone thinks you are very powerful.
Thank you. Okay, let's do that again.
All of his co-workers were gone.
Dichika, hi, how are you doing? It's so happy to see you. How are you? How was your weekend? I hope you're doing okay. Now, let's go for the red door this time.
When Stanley came to a set of two open doors, this was not the correct way to the meeting room.
I wonder how many more endings there are, guys.
Perhaps he wanted to stop by the employee lounge first, just to admire it. Standing now in this incredible room, Stanley for the first
time. Place your bets. Will she miss a new content Stanley again next time? Which new content? Left. Every time she goes past a new content door, I die a little.
Stanley,
wait, what do you
so
mean?
Bad at following directions.
We've gone through that door, right?
5 years ago.
That's a new content. We did that, right? I mean, we
Look,
still
Stanley,
got to explore if there's multiple endings there.
The
but we did
here.
Go through it.
I'm not your enemy, really.
I think.
I'm not.
Right?
I realize that investing your trust in someone else can be difficult, but the fact is that the story has been about nothing but
you all this time. We're going to jump down.
Someone you've been neglecting, Stanley. Someone you've forgotten about.
Woohoo!
Really?
There we go.
I was in the middle of something. Do you have zero consideration for others? Are you that convinced that I want something bad to happen to you? Why? I don't know how to convince you of this, but I really do want to help you, to show you something beautiful. Look, let me prove it. Let me prove that I'm on your side. Give me a chance. Now listen carefully, this is important. Stanley walked through the red door.
There we go.
Oh, thank God you are willing to listen to me. Do you see that I really have wanted you to be happy all this time? The problem is all these choices. The two of us always trying to get somewhere that isn't here. Running and running and running, just the way you're doing right now. Don't you see that it's killing us, Stanley? I want it to stop. We would both be so much happier if we just stopped. And I think, I think I have a solution.
No more choices?
Here, let me show you.
Oh, is he killing me?
What do we want? What are we looking for?
This reminds me of the Superliminal, right?
Here. Yes. Oh, it's beautiful, isn't it? If we just stay right here, right in this moment with this place, Stanley, No, wait. Where are you going?
Is this Domino Pete? No, it's not Domino's.
Oh, no. Stay away from those stairs. If you hurt yourself, if you die, the game will reset. We'll lose all of this. Please, no, Stanley, let me stay here. Don't take this from me.
Please, Stanley, think about what you're doing.
Uh-oh. Are we doing this? Are we doing this? I mean, that doesn't seem... okay.
No!
Ah!
Oh, thank God. You lived. You had me worried there for a moment. Now, can we please get back to the other room?
No.
What are you doing, Stanley? Please, I'm asking you not to take this away from me. I can't go back to what I was before. If you die, we'll both go back. Why are you doing this?
Oh, I feel kind of sorry, actually.
Stanley, let's go back to the other room. Can you do that for me?
Oh, no, I feel so sorry now.
My God, is this really how much you dislike my game? But you'll throw yourself from this platform over and over to be rid of it? You're literally willing to kill yourself to keep me from being happy. Am I reading the situation correctly?
No! Yeah?
Or maybe you're just getting a kick out of it. I don't know anymore. I just wanted us to get along.
Up.
I guess that was too much to ask.
No!
It looks like you wanted to make a choice after all.
No!
Well, this one is yours.
No, I feel so guilty now. Oh, this is so sad. I want the funny game back, please.
Is it over?
Oh.
It's going to restart, isn't it? I'm going back.
All of his co-workers were gone. What could
it
mean?
Not do that?
Stanley decided to go to the meeting
room. Is that an option?
Perhaps he had simply missed a memo.
Thank you for the hug for the stream, Woozy. I really appreciate it. New content. I see. We're gonna do that
when
then.
When Stanley came to a set of two open doors, this was not the correct way to the meeting room, and Stanley
knew it
perfectly
if we don't
well. Perhaps he wanted to stop by
there,
the employee lounge first, just to admire it. Stanley felt lightheaded. Butterflies in his stomach. But eager to get back to business, Stanley took the first open door on his left.
Two news. Yeah, you're right. I did not notice
that
at all.
Stanley was so bad at following directions.
I so much presumed that it just said new content that I didn't look at it at all.
Look, Stanley, I think perhaps we've gotten off.
Content warning for this ending. If you're triggered by the patient of suicide, please tune out for a bit. Thanks for that, Chris.
I realize that investing in
thank
your
you, I really appreciate that.
Else
that's
can
great.
Be difficult.
Thank
but
you.
But the fact is that the story has been about nothing but you.
There are no other options
time.
There? That's the only. Okay, that's
this
good to know. Thanks. Then I'll just continue
Stanley.
Here.
Someone you've forgotten about.
I think that was
please.
It then.
Stop trying to make every decision by yourself. Now, I'm not asking for me. I'm asking for her. This is it, Stanley.
Let's see if there's anything
your
else that
chance
we can do
to
here.
Redeem yourself. To put your work aside. To let her back into your life. She's been waiting.
Please go left of the employee room before you go to do the new content. I'm not exactly sure what you're talking about, but I'll take a look.
That's her, Stanley.
There you go.
You need to... Oh, no, you can't... Did you just unplug the phone? Well, that wasn't supposed to be a choice. How did you do that? You actually chose incorrectly? I didn't even know that was possible. Let me double check. No, it's definitely here, clear as day. Stanley picks up the phone. He's taken to his apartment where he finds his wife, and the two pledge themselves to one another. Music comes in, fade to white, roll credits.
That's not what
not
happens,
picking
though.
Up the phone is actually somehow an incorrect course of action. How is that even possible? None of these decisions were supposed to mean anything. I don't understand. How on earth are you making meaningful choices? What did you... Wait a second. Did I just see... No, that's not possible. I can't believe it. How had I not noticed it sooner? You're not Stanley. You're a real person. I can't believe I was so mistaken. This is why you've been able to make correct and incorrect choices. And to think I've been letting you run around in this game for so long. If you've made any more wrong choices, you might have negated it entirely. It's as though you completely ignored even the most basic safety protocol for real-world decision-making. Or did you not grasp the severity of the situation? Well, I won't have that kind of risk on my watch. I'm going to stop the game for a moment so we can educate you properly on safe decision-making in the real world. Please observe this helpful instructional video.
Oh. Choice. It's the best part of being a real person. But if used incorrectly, can also be the most dangerous. For example, in this scenario, a hypothetical real person named Rupert has a choice. He could invent a machine that eliminates food shortages across the world to make life better for all people. Or he could spend years of hard work forgetting how to read. Which choice would you make? Remember that unlike here, the real world makes sense, and at no time should you make a choice that does not conform to rational logic. If you find yourself speaking with a person who does not make sense, in all likelihood, that person is not real. Allow the person to finish their thought.
Are you guys then not real? Is that what that means?
Why you cannot continue talking. Turn to a partner and practice saying, "My goodness, is it 4:30? I'm supposed to be having a back sack and crack." Excellent. Making choices on a regular basis is the best part to a healthy decision-making process. Most medical professionals recommend making at least 8 choices per day. Do you make more than 8? Less? And finally, If you begin to wonder if your choices are actually meaningful and whether you'll ever make a significant contribution to the world, just remember that in the vast infiniteness of space, your thoughts and problems are materially insignificant.
Oh, that's
and
great.
And the feeling should subside. At this time, your instructor will guide you in an exercise to test and reinforce the material covered in this video.
Ah, welcome back. Oh. You may have noticed that this room has begun to deteriorate as a result of narrative contradiction. But not to worry. Now that you're properly informed on good decision-making, we're going to revisit a choice you made just a few minutes ago and see what the correct thing to do would have been. This way, please.
Let's see if we can unplug it again. Oh. What? It has barriers now.
If your choices are meaningful, we can't have you jumping off the platform and dying. Imagine the main character dying senselessly halfway through the story. That story would make no sense at all. We just need to get you home as soon as possible before the narrative contradiction gets any worse. Unfortunately, it seems this place is not well equipped to deal with reality.
He's just locking us in everywhere now. There we go. Let's see. Back in the employee room.
Almost there. You'll take the door on the left, back to the correct ending, the story will have resolution once again, and you'll be home free in the real world.
Will we have a choice?
Now remember, all you need to do is behave exactly as Stanley would. That means choosing responsibly and always putting the story first. I'm quite sure you'll be up to the task. Just follow my lead and you'll be fine. All right. When Stanley came to a set of two open doors, he entered the door on his left. No! Why did you do that? Quickly, hurry back in the other direction. Perhaps we're not too late.
Can I do anything else? Or do I have to go back now? I think we have to go back. That's what I was thinking too. I wonder if you can get over the fence somehow. I don't think so, because we can't jump. Yeah, we don't have a choice now. Quiet. Ah, there we go.
It's ruined. I can't believe, after everything we talked about, my story, you've destroyed my work. Why? For what? What did you get out of that? What did you think was so special about seeing
door.
The game undone? Left here like so much garbage. It's worthless now. And what am I supposed to do? Even if there were a way to continue, would it be worth it? To know that my story is now incorrect? How can I go back to that? I can't erase that knowledge. I'll have to live with it forever, reliving its impossibility forever. I couldn't live that way. Is it better to shut the game down entirely? To willingly destroy all of my work? I don't know. What's the answer? What do I do? What do I do? What do I... No, I have to. I have to shut the game down. I have to. I have to.
Oh? Oh?
I'm here. I'm still here. Here in this pile of rubbish. With you. You. Who thought you were so clever. Now look where we are. My entire game is destroyed. It was the only thing in the world that was mine, and you've run it into the ground. What, did you think that would be funny? You just had to see? Didn't I impress upon you how important it was to be like Stanley? He actually knows how to do what I tell him to. He understands that if I say to do something, there's a damn good reason for it. That thought hadn't even occurred to you, had it? That there's a world outside of you? You're a child. Oh, my story. If you'd just gone through the door on the left, you would have seen it. There was a whole underground facility. You would have destroyed it and been victorious. It would have been so perfect. I worked so hard on it. I tried so hard to make... ...behave exactly as Stanley would. That means choosing responsibly and always putting the story first. I'm quite sure you'll be up to the task. Just follow my lead and you'll be fine. All right. When Stanley came to a set of two open doors, he entered the door on his left.
What do we do now, guys? What do we do now? You guys tell me. Left or right now? I thought the game was gonna close. That would be great. That would be so good. That's the... Something with one... Oh, I forgot the name. But this really... Oh, what's the name? One shot. That's the name. One shot interacts with your computer and files on your computer, which is freaking amazing. I love that game. One of my favorite. Because it really messes with your mind because everything happens on, like, actually on your computer as well, which is just amazing. We got one for left and three for right. Chevin, hi. Welcome to the stream. How are you doing? Okay, obviously right, guys. Obviously right. I mean, You snooze, you lose, Chris. You snooze, you lose. Well, actually, you were first, but...
No! You lose. Why did you do that? Quickly, hurry back.
Oh!
...is behave exactly as Stanley would. That means choosing responsibly...
I don't think we have a choice.
...always putting the story first.
I don't think we have
I'm
a choice.
I'm sure you'll be up to the task. Just follow my lead and you'll be fine. All right. When Stanley came to a set of two open doors, he entered the door on his left.
Never do as the narrator tells you to do. Yeah, but I don't have a choice now. Because it just restarts to this moment, unfortunately. Sounds like fun game to stream? Yeah, I mean, it absolutely is. But I played it already, so it wouldn't be like my blind reaction to it. I would keep going, right? Of course you would, Goku. Of course you would.
Yet there was not a single person here either.
It's not looking
Feeling
great, though.
A wave of disbelief, Stanley decided to go up to his boss's office, hoping he might find an answer there.
This is close this time.
Coming to a staircase,
we can't go
Stanley
down.
Walked upstairs to his boss's office.
All the choices are gone now. See if we can open this. Nope. All the choices are gone. That's gone. This is different, though.
Stepping inside his manager's office, Stanley was once again stunned to discover not an indication of any human life. Shocked, unraveled, Stanley wondered in disbelief who orchestrated this, until he saw the door with a voice receiver next to it. Surely behind this door lay all the answers to his questions. And beyond all probability, he knew the passcode. He had seen it on his boss's computer just last week. Nightshark 115. Was
what?
This the code
That's
to
different.
Open the door? Would it still work? There was only one way to find out. Stanley had been trained never to speak up, but now he would draw from within himself the courage to face the unknown. He drew a sharp breath and then spoke the code.
I can't. I can't.
Stanley spoke the code. Nightshark 115. He spoke it into the receiver, right there on the wall.
I can't. Don't
I'm
have
sorry,
an option.
Is there a problem? You didn't mishear me, did you? Please speak the code into the receiver. Otherwise, we can't get on with the story. This is a crucial step. Okay, fine, you're not gonna do it, but you know what? It's pretty humiliating to bring you this far, only for you to suddenly decide you have better things to do. I asked you for this one single thing, for your respect. The kind of respect Stanley shows for his choices. He knows what it means to take a story seriously. If you didn't want to see what I had to show you, then why did you come here? You had a choice, you know. You could have gone through the door on the right. You could have done whatever the hell you wanted over there. Why did you come this way? Speak. Say something to me. Explain yourself, you coward. You... When
And Stanley came to a set of two open doors.
Oh.
He entered the door on his left. Stanley? Hello? Are you... Is everything okay? Stanley, please. I need you to make a choice.
DMs?
I need you to walk through the door. Are you listening?
Alternate Alex.
Can you hear me? Is everything all right?
What?
Stanley, this is important.
We're actually getting
story
end
needs
credits?
I need you to make a decision. It cannot exist without you. Do you understand me? Whatever
choice what?
You make is just fine. They're both correct. You cannot be wrong here. We can work together. I'll accept whatever you do. I simply need you to take that step forward, please. Choose. Do something. This is more important than you can ever
I feel
know.
So sad for the guy.
I need this. The story needs it. So, you hear me? Are you there? Are you listening to this? Stanley, are you there? Okay. It's okay, I can wait. You need time to decide. Time to make sure your choice is correct. That is the best choice.
No!
I'll wait for you to decide what's the right thing to do. Take as much time as you need.
Oh, poor guy. I think we're going to jump off here. Oh, no, we're not. There you go. So wait, what did I have to do now, Quaggan? Let me see. Please go left after the employee room before you do the new content. Okay, we'll do that. We'll try that now. Wait, was there another option? No, I think, okay. We did the other door now, so we don't have to do that. There are no other options, but there's a lot of other voice lines. Okay. My family home, let's see how Cheshire will die today. Hi, Addas. We don't die. Well, actually, we died a few times. That's not true. How was work? I'm happy to hear you're done now. The narrator's transatlantic accent is great. Yeah, I love the narrator so much. What's Redding? I'm the fakest of all people. I knew it. I knew it, Addas. Sounds like a fun game to stream. It's great. I'm loving the game so much. I would just keep going, right? You will never know what to 100 time it might change. That's true. But I have a feeling we did things like that in the game. I have a feeling then nothing would have happened, but... Okay. What if we stay there in the calm room? Was that an option? In the
All
calm room.
All of his co-workers
room.
Were gone. What could it mean?
You mean
Stanley
where the narrator was so happy?
Perhaps
apparently
he
that wasn't
a memo.
An option. Left after the employee room, right?
When Stanley came to a
I
set
want,
of two open
I
want to
see
doors,
what happens if we don't
he
make
entered
a choice
the door
here.
On his left.
Because when we were up there, we didn't make a choice and there was this whole dialogue thing. Yeah, probably. Okay. So, employee room is... Wait, which way is the employee room? This way?
This was not the correct way to the meeting room, and Stanley knew it perfectly well. Perhaps he wanted to stop by the employee lounge first,
yeah.
just
okay.
to admire it.
So after
the lounge
this,
was grand,
we gotta go left.
Majestic. Perhaps too much, but eager to get back to business, Stanley took the first open door on his left. And so he detoured through the maintenance section, walked straight ahead to the opposite door, and got back on track.
Yeah, we haven't done this yet. Wait, have we done this?
But Stanley didn't want to go back to the office. He wanted to wander about and get even further off track. So now in order to get back, he needed to go,
from here, it's, left.
Can't do that. Don't have a choice.
Oh, no. Oh. No, it's to the right. My mistake. No, not the right. Why would I have ever said it was to the right? What was I thinking? It's clearly... Oh, dear, would you hold on for a minute, please?
Take your time.
See, we went down right, left,
down, left, right. Yep. Okay, yes. I've got it now. This story is absolutely, definitely this way.
Okay. Creepy white van. I don't think we're going the right way. Oh!
No. This isn't right at all. You're not supposed to be here yet. This is all a spoiler. Quick, Stanley, close your
Excuse
eyes.
Excuse me, Quaggan.
Okay. We just have to get back to, oh. Who am I kidding? It's all rubbish now. The whole story completely unusable. How about, rather than waste my time trying to salvage this nonsense, we'll just restart the game from the beginning. And this time, suppose we don't wander so far off track, hmm? Okay, from the top. All of his co-workers were gone.
Should we do what the same thing mean? Again?
Stanley decided to go to the meeting room. Perhaps he had simply missed a memo.
See what happens if we do it
when
again.
Wait, what? No, I restarted. I swear, I definitely restarted the game over, completely fresh. Everything should be... Oh, did something change? Stanley, did you change anything when we were back in that room with all the monitors? Did you move the story somewhere or... Hold on. Why am I asking you? I'm the one who wrote the story. It was right here just a minute ago. I know for sure that it's here somewhere. Okay, then. It's an adventure. Come, Stanley.
Oh, God.
Let's find the story.
Oh, God. Oh, no. We're gonna get so lost. Oh, God. I know. Just sticking to random things now. It's actually leading somewhere. Nope, it's not. Oh God. Oh no.
I'll say it. This is the worst adventure I've ever been on. I can promise you there definitely was a story here before. Do we need to restart the game again? Well, I find it unlikely that we'll ever progress by starting over and over again. But it's got to be better than this. Okay, let's give it a shot. Why not?
I remember this one. This is great. Now what?
All of his co-workers were gone. What could it mean? Stanley decided to go to the meeting room. Perhaps he had simply missed a memo.
Let's see. No doors.
Okay, yep, it's worse. I might be remembering this wrong. It's possible the story is back where we just came from. Why don't we go back the other direction and see if we missed anything? Aha! I knew we'd miss something. The story. Here it comes. Wait, never mind. Not the story. Okay, let's head back the other way and retrace our steps.
Oh!
Now this...
Oh!
Well, I'll be honest, I don't recognize this place at all. Is this the story? I don't think so. I can't quite recall, but I believe my story took place in an office building. Is that correct? Do you remember, Stanley? Well, do you know what? Since I've completely forgotten what we were supposed to be doing, how about this? You win!
Ooh!
Congratulations!
Yay!
I know you put in a lot of hard work, and it really paid off. So, good job. Oh, no. No, I don't feel right about this at all. We both know you didn't put in any actual work for that win. Some people win fair and square, and this was not one of those situations. Okay, I'm getting weirded out by whatever this place is. I don't care what might happen this time, I have to restart.
The Stanley Parable Adventure
Life. I've got a solution. This time, to make sure we don't get lost, I've employed the help of the Stanley Parable Adventure Line. Just follow the line. How simple is that?
This is new. Look, finally we can see that someone was playing solitaire. We saw it from the window. Let's see if we get any choices here.
You see? What? The line knows where the story is. It's over in this direction. Onward, Stanley, to destiny. Though, here's a thought. Wouldn't wherever we end up be our destination, even if there's no story there? Or to put it another way, is the story of no destination still a story? Simply by the act of moving forward, are we implying a journey such that a destination is inevitably conjured into being via the very manifestation of the nature of life itself?
Okay, Stanley, I need to follow this train of thought for a minute. Just stick with me.
Now, we can both agree that the nature of existence is in fact a byproduct of one's subjective experience of that existence, right? Okay, now if my experience of your existence rests inside of your subjective experience of this office, is this office in fact the skeleton of my own relative experiential mental subjective construct?
Whoa, excuse me?
Hang on. That got a bit weird back there. Well, I'd like to apologize. Not sure where I was going with all that. You know what? I think what we need right now is a bit of music to lighten the mood.
Oh, okay. That is some music. Gotta see what happens over here. Oh. What? Okay, we don't have a choice. You guys. You guys. Nothing. If you've been drinking it, actually, yes, would it? Actually, yes. Hi, how are you doing? Hope you can hear me. What the frick? What? This is so strange. Wait, what? Wait, what? Wait, what? I'm so confused. I'm so confused.
Wait, cut the music. Go back and look at that fern. Stanley. This fern will be very important later in the story. Make sure you study it closely and remember it carefully. You won't want to miss anything.
Yes, sir. Studying it closely. That is a nice fern, guys. That's a nice fern. Looking good? Looking good? I will remember this for sure. In your head? Was that a bit loud by any chance, Goku?
Wait, what?
Oh God.
We're back at the office? No.
Seek the
line, you do know we're looking for the Stanley Parable, right? The story? Is any of this ringing a bell?
But how are you doing, Wooden? I'm so happy to see you. If you're playing music like this for TwitchCon, I would kill to see it with my own eyes. So then you would come. I see how it is. I see. Wait, what? Then, what if we go this way? Oh, we're back to the beginning. But what happens if we go back inside the door? Nothing. You're okay, you just finished work? Well, I'm happy to hear that. I hope you have a nice, relaxing evening ahead of you now. I hope so. Okay. Now what? Where's my I miss my music, guys. Oh, look!
No, not again, Line. How could you have done this to us? But after we trusted you, after everything we've been through, you...
Oh, I can't take this anymore. To hell with it. Restart.
Now what? The Stanley Parable Adventure Line. Spotato, hi! Oh, welcome to the stream. I hope you're doing good.
You know what, Stanley?
Let's sing the Adventure Line song. Yes, please. Line.
What's it ever done for us? We're intelligent people, right? Why can't we make up our own story? Something exciting,
yes.
Deep,
yes.
Mysterious.
Yes.
Ooh, this all sounds perfectly doable. Why don't we simply start wandering in? Well, I don't know.
Thank you, Chris.
Now,
I appreciate
yes,
that. I can hear it in my head
exciting.
Already.
Just me and Stanley forging a new path, a new story. Well, it could be anything. What do you want our story to be? Go wild. Use your imagination. Whatever it might be, Stanley, I'm ready for it.
I don't think Stanley has imagination. I think nothing is coming.
Oh, no, not you again. Stanley, I'd also like to veto the line from having any role in our awesome new story. No lines or monitor rooms. Just don't acknowledge it, and we should be fine.
It's everywhere, though. Trademark. Trademark is a real thing. Wait, what? But why? Yeah, why does the line have a trademark, guys? Bring back the music. Yes, please. Yeah, is it a reference to something, guys? The line trademark thing?
A choice. We get to make a decision. From here, the story is in our control. How important, we mustn't squander the opportunity. In fact, I believe I need a minute to think here. Just walk in circles for a minute. Okay, so I know that each door has to lead somewhere, which means that somewhere, the place where we're trying to go, there must be a reverse door that leads here. And that in turn means that our destination corresponds with the counter-inverted reverse door's origin.
Yes,
I agree.
So starting
from the right, let us ask, will taking the right door lead us to where we're going? And since the answer is clearly yes, then by all accounts, the door on the right is the correct one. Another victory for logic. Come, Stanley, our destiny awaits.
Which one was the door on the right, though? How do you know? How do you remember? Can we try the other doors? No. Okay. The confusion ending.
What's this? The confusion ending. You're telling me that's what this is? It's all one giant ending? And we're supposed to restart the game eight times? That's really
after a long time Stanley dies?
It's all determined? So now, according to the schedule, I restart again. Then what? Am I just supposed to forget? Well, what if I don't want to forget? My mind goes blank simply because it's written here on this thing, wall. Well, who consulted me? Why don't I get to decide? Why don't I get a say in all of this? Is it really? No, it can't be. I don't want it to be. I don't want the game to keep restarting. I don't want to forget what's going on. I don't want to be trapped like this. I won't restart the game. I won't do it. I won't do it. I won't do it. And the timer stopped? Does that mean, did we do it? Did we break the cycle? The, whatever it is that made this schedule? How would we even know? Will someone come for us? Will something happen? So, okay. I guess now we just wait, you know. I suppose in some way that this is a kind of story, wouldn't you agree? I'm not quite sure if we're in the destination or the journey. Though they're always saying that life is about the journey and not the destination. So I hope that's where we are right now. We'll find out, won't we? Eventually. Well, in the meantime, if you...
Oh, Jesus Christ! Think that was an ending. Was it? No.
All of his co-workers were gone. What could it mean? Stanley decided
that
to go
was
to the
an
meeting
ending.
Room. Perhaps he had simply missed a memo.
The confusion ending. Yeah, so now...
when Stanley came to a set of two open doors. This was not the correct way to the meeting room, and Stanley knew it perfectly
well.
Haven't
done everything in that way, right? Do I stop yet? No, never stop the music, please. I'm missing it so much.
The lounge.
New Contatine, didn't we?
Eager to get back to business.
Have we done everything
Stanley
there?
Stanley took the first open door on his left.
Yeah, but
and
not
so
something
he detoured
here?
Through the maintenance section, walked straight ahead to the opposite door, and got back on track.
No? Are we not missing things here? I've done everything except the new content. Oh, okay, sorry. I don't think I can get back to there, though.
Yet there was not a single person here either.
Feeling what is the easiest way to get there again?
Stanley decided to go up to his boss's office, coming to a staircase.
Oh, something I want
to
try. Do you guys know the code? Can you guys type the code out for me? Can you guys type the code out for me, please? Joel, hi! Welcome to the stream. How are you doing? The game devs released a soundtrack album. Wait, did they? Oh my god, I'm gonna listen to that all the time. 2845. Okay, let's see what
Stepping
happens when we fill it
office,
in immediately.
Stanley was once again stunned to discover not an indication of
two,
any human
eight,
life.
Four,
shocked,
five.
Stanley was in such a rush to get through the story as quickly as possible, he didn't even have a single minute to just let the narrator talk. That kind of anxiety isn't healthy, so he relaxed for a few moments with some calming New Age music.
We did this one already, right? Okay, so you say restart then, Chris? Begin the game again? Let's do that. Hi, Joel, how are you doing? I hope you're doing good. Spotato, you are nothing if not very persistent. I very much appreciate that. Thank you. It's not the same as hearing the song, but, you know, it at least kind of makes up for it. Did we do everything on left? I thought the elevator in the cabin room had an ending. Did I miss something with the elevator? Because we did go in the elevator, but just nothing happened. We went up and we went down. And in both...
Just a step through this
nothing
door,
happened
Stanley
then.
Thought to himself, that's all I need.
The OST is on YouTube? Okay,
door,
awesome.
I
will have to look that up for sure. Okay, new content,
oh, good.
Guys.
You notice my sign. Yes, I have something very exciting to show you.
Okay. Now what? Okay. We've done this before.
You see, Stanley, I've been reflecting on the Stanley Parable and about how roundly disappointing this ultra-deluxe version has turned out to be. The original Stanley Parable was a landmark, and any new content for it should live up to that legacy. So forget this ultra-deluxe nonsense. I say we take it one step even further. Which is why I'm very proud to announce for the first time ever, the Stanley Parable 2.
Oh? Okay.
Yes, you see, isn't this far superior to a measly re-release with a few minor additions? Think of all the new territory we'll cover with a fully fledged
Again.
Sequel. An entirely new experience built from the ground up. Why, there are so many possibilities. It could go in so many different directions. This is what fans have truly been asking for.
Taste the
for.
Sequel.
Calling it the Stanley Parable 2 is just so much catchier than Ultra Deluxe, don't you think? Ultra Deluxe? What does it even mean? But the Stanley Parable 2, now that's an artistic statement right there. It's future-oriented. It screams progress and innovation and long-term franchising potential.
The Stanley Parable 2, there we go. Is this a slide? Oh my god, it's a Google Docs, isn't it? They're working on it in Google Docs!
Now to be clear, I haven't quite nailed down what exactly the Stanley Parable 2 is going to be, but let's take a look at some of the features I've been developing for it. I figure that if I can loosely organize a handful of interesting concepts, that surely the game will sort of naturally spring up around them. It'll all work itself out.
Does game look very fancy.
Is much more of a fuzzy magic than anything scientific or logical, really.
Okay. Oh, wow. Fancy.
Here we are. Go on. Try out some of the new features.
The button that says the name of the player that is playing the game. Reassurance bucket. I wanna know about this button. Please, no screenshots. Oh? Why? What's causing the interference, I wonder? Gems! Hi! How are you doing, Gems? I'm so happy to see you! How are you? How's your day been today? I hope you've been having a good day. Let me see if I'm missing anything, guys. I'm sorry. It's very difficult to play this game and read chat. Because there's a lot of talking happening. The elevator doesn't know. What do you mean with the cabin room? Okay. It was going on forever. The elevator? Yeah, right? It just kept going. The broom closet. But we've done the broom closet, right? We went in there. Oh, I missed some secrets there? Look at the mugs, they're very funny. I'm sorry, I'll look at mugs now. If there's still mugs, I don't know if there's still any. Press F12, just trust me. I don't know, you have not done anything yet to make me trust you. You gotta earn my trust first, you know? Let's see. No jumps. Mm-hmm, player team. I don't know if I can read that. I want to see this button. I'm very excited about this button.
For the Stanley Parable 2, I asked myself, what do players
Bro, it's
really
a perfect
want?
Button. Too big,
course,
too small,
the first
just right.
And most obvious answer is that they want to be individually recognized and validated as people. So with that in mind, my first addition to the game is this button, which speaks the name of the person playing the game. Isn't that wonderful?
Will it say Stanley?
Jim.
So, I should have clarified. Right now, the button only says the name Jim. But of course, in the final game, this button will say your name, whatever name that is. Here, let's have you role play as Jim to really simulate the full experience of this feature. Just play along. I promise you'll love it.
Okay.
Okay, here we go. Let's take a deep breath, clear your mind, forget whoever you are, and simply become a person named Jim. I want you to imagine yourself living as Jim, sleeping and waking as Jim, falling in love and being heartbroken as Jim, seizing all of the world's possibilities as Jim, and as Jim, watching your dreams crumble into dust. Do you feel it deeply? Are you really, truly
so
Jim
deeply.
Right now?
Yeah.
If so, then please step forward and press the button.
Oh, my memories, guys! Oh, my memories! Oh, no, my dreams! It's all crumbling to dust!
Jim!
Yes! You see? What a thrill! What a rush! That was you! The button described you! Do it again! Do it again!
Jim!
It hits even harder the second time. If this were the only new feature in the Stanley Parable 2, it would still be worth the money. Let's take a break from the gym button. I'm too emotionally drained from all of this personal validation.
Don't rewatch the VOD, Gems. You definitely didn't mispronounce your name again, did I? I was just sticking to Gems now to try to not mispronounce it anymore. That's my cheat. Oh, you can crouch! Can I? Oh, I can! I didn't know that. Okay, great. We'll do that for the mugs now. Hi, Jim. Hi, Spotato. Thank you for recognizing my name. I feel so validated right now. I'm alright. Didn't sleep. Oh, no. Didn't sleep very well. Very much or well. So anxiety has been bugging me. I was on the phone waiting for almost half an hour with the internet company. How are you? Did you manage to get anywhere with the internet company? And I'm so sorry to hear that, Gems. That really, really sucks. Oh, I hope tonight will be a whole lot better for you. I hope tonight will be, like, the opposite of your last night, basically. And I'm doing okay. I had a pretty okay day. I'm doing pretty well. And I had an amazing weekend, which really helped, so. Imagine if your name actually was Jim. I would be mind blown. Doctor! Oh, I'm so happy to see you. How are you doing, Doctor? How have you been? How was your weekend? How was your day today? I want to know it all. I hope you're doing good. I'm so, so happy to see you again. You don't mind how people say it, but I mind, Gems. I mind that I've been calling you by the wrong name for so long now. Enough is enough, you know? By the way, it's embarrassing to admit, but we did a lot of bowling, right, on Saturday? And I actually have muscle pain right now in my arm from the bowling, and my fingers are hurting too. I wish I was kidding. I'm not. It's only in this arm because I've been using this arm for bowling. Okay, for bowling. Let that be correct. That's bowling. I hope you guys will understand what I'm saying. Only this arm hurts now because of the bowling. They were very nice, and I got a message that the problem is fixed, so I put a game on download to see, and it seems to be... Oh, I'm so happy to hear that, Gems. I'm so, so happy to hear that. That's great. Okay, hopefully it will stay that way. Because for everyone who doesn't know, on Sunday is Gems' streamiversary, and she's going to be doing a 12-hour stream, right, Gems? So obviously, everyone should be tuning in and watch that, obviously, you guys. But yeah, I hope everything's working correctly, because it would be amazing if that can continue to happen. Does that mean you can crouch walk inside that area that was near the white van? It looked like there was something there. I might be wrong. Oh, really? Where was that again? Oh, there's so many ways to go that... Was it when you went down the button elevator thingy, maybe? Pain in arm and fingers? I know, right? From bowling. No pain, no gain. Arm pain from playing with balls for too long. That is very correct there, Mikes. You are very much understanding the situation completely and utterly correctly.
Jim. Press that again. There, cowboy. Sometimes a person can be too much, Jim. I'm putting the gym button away.
No!
Otherwise, soon you'll start to lose all sense of who you actually are.
Here. Still there. There we go. Okay. It is gone. God damn it. I was hoping we could crouch to reach it. Can we hit these buttons? No, we can't. Okay. Now, let's see what other content there is, guys. I want to know about the reassurance bucket.
I suppose I could allow any people named Jim to play the Stanley Parable 2. That would actually save me the work of finishing this feature.
Merge! There's merge! Wait, I want to see. Can we scan this? I want to see, guys. Let's see. Nope, we cannot. Oh, can we? No, we cannot. That's a shame. I saw the new content. It's a new content. Thank you very much. They're back. Two doors. No screenshot? Oh, we gotta go in there too. So the Stanley Parable reassurance bucket, office decorations, infinite hole, and we can go up as well. It's uncanny. Stop playing the new stuff I can't watch. I'm sorry, Doctor, I'm sorry, but apparently it's one of the only things that we still have left. I'm so sorry. It's a Prime version, it's been available for a while. Oh, the color. I see. You scanned it? Wait, you did? Takes you to the stank? Wait, what? You can scan it. It takes you to a website. Wait. Okay, wait. I want to go back there then. Why didn't it work for me? Wait, let me... Maybe I need to be more like this. Let's try again. There we go! It does actually work. Welcome to the official website of the Stanley Parable 2. Taste a sequel, now in Expo Hall 2. A sequel, huh? That's new. Wait, let me see. Wait, let me see if I can show that to you guys. Oh no. I can't for some reason. Maybe there was a mistake in the thing? There I go. This one seems to work, I think. Does it? No. Also doesn't work. Can't show you guys right now. No. I can't show you guys. Sorry. But everyone can look it up themselves because it's not working for me right now. This one? Yeah, that works. Okay, let's see. Now I need to show it. There you go. Look at that. Taste the sequel, now in Expo Hall 2. Learn more? A sequel, huh? Watch our helpful and informative video to learn more about the Stanley Parable and what the journey of becoming a sequel is all about. That's new. If you're more of a sequels, prequel sort of person, check out the Stanley Parable. Thanks for stopping by. Enjoy the rest of the exhibit. Join the Crows Discord or follow us on Twitter. Wait, let me see if I can... Can you guys hear this? I hope you guys can hear it.
See there, Timmy. What's that you're enjoying? Why, it's breakfast, of course. Everyone loves breakfast. But did you know that breakfast is getting a sequel? That's right. It's called Lunch. And critics are raving that Lunch will be
you can hear it?
Breakfast
okay, cool.
was and more. With a little luck, we may even get a trilogy series out of it. Say, you know what a sequel is, don't you, Timmy?
It is, Gasly.
Sequels are the world's way
first
of
time ever.
Hopelessly to the past. We Wait. All want more of the things we love, and we're all afraid of change, which is what makes sequels so popular. New ideas are dangerous, Timmy, and they can lead to early aging. This eager-minded young thinker is just 29 years old. That's why we have sequels, to keep us couched in the familiar and the comfortable. Sequels are the bedrock of a healthy, functional society. And if you look around you, you'll find them everywhere you go.
Do we know?
For instance, this man is developing a sequel to the automobile, which we'll call the vertical automobile. It's a useless, impractical invention. And in 2 days' time, the man will be publicly stoned to death for his crimes against gravity. Not all sequels are heretical nonsense, however. Here's the man who invented breathing, which is the sequel to suffocating and dying a slow death. Even your parents are getting a sequel to me. Their names are Rob and Jessica, and they'll be taking care of you once your original parents are sent back in time to fight a secret war for the government. Sequels can be very fashionable. This young woman is wearing 5 shirts at once, which is the sequel to wearing 4 shirts at once. Look at Becky over there, wearing only 2 shirts at once. Get with the times, Becky.
Poor
in fact,
Becky.
There is only one single thing in the world that isn't a sequel. It's this. We don't know what it is or why it exists, but it's the prequel from which all sequels are derived. And just like everything else, the Stanley Parable is getting a sequel too. We all know, of course, that it was your favorite game as a child.
This is the way
don't you remember
the Chinese
those long,
really
easy
helps.
Afternoons you spent playing the Stanley Parable, watching your precious youth fritter away hour after hour. We've all wasted our childhoods in one way or another, and you were fortunate enough to get to waste yours on the Stanley Parable. But the Stanley Parable came out years ago, and you're not a child anymore. You're a man, which is like the sequel
Am
to
I?
A child. And as a
Am
man,
I?
You want manly
is
things
a sequel
like
to a
Texas
child?
And cheating at baseball. You need a man's video game, Timmy. And that's why the Stanley Parable 2 will be perfect for you.
The
it's
man's
as manly
game.
As video games
oh, wow.
Get. And if you don't believe me, let's look at the burly hunk of a man who's responsible for the game. Huh, here he is, hard at work. His name is Gregory Eightpack. And he's the cutting picture of raw, virile masculinity.
Is
Gregory
he now?
Is what we call the ideas guy, and he has the most important role on the team. The ideas guy tirelessly comes up with interesting concepts and then hands them off to the rest of the developers for the relatively simple job of turning those concepts into reality. For example,
relatively
he's the
simple.
One who picked up the phone and declared, "Someone ought to make a sequel to the Stanley Parable." Good work, Gregory. Go ahead and take the rest of the day off. With the hard part out of the way, work on the game can now begin. The game's developers must answer a simple question. What makes a sequel in the first place? Well, it's simple. Sequels are an opportunity to correct the mistakes of their predecessors. We've all made mistakes, and we've all caused harm to someone we love in order to cover up our mistakes.
Have we all done that?
When developing this particular sequel, it's important to start by thinking, what mistakes did the original Stanley Parable make? Well, first
we're in the lead group, Goku.
Most of the pornography in the original game was stolen or pirated. And it's time we paid the licensing fees fair and square.
What the freak?
The Stanley Parable was catastrophic for this man named Leroy, whose personal information, including home address, social security number, and bank information, were all displayed prominently in multiple locations throughout the game. Although Leroy's money and identity were stolen, the fact remains that his personal information was the emotional core of the game, and absolutely vital to a nuanced understanding of the story. As reparation for the harm we caused him, the sequel will contain a brief and insincere apology to Leroy tucked deep within the game where it will be difficult to find. Finally, the Stanley Parable made the mistake of leaking too many government secrets about the nature of the Time Wars. Without these intricate details of specific military tactics, the story is likely to make very little sense. But we've decided to remove them from the sequel in the interest of helping the state's efforts. We'll get to you yet, Time Dracula.
Excuse me?
It's time to set about constructing the Stanley Parable 2. Game development is a difficult and complex art, one which can only be fully understood by this race of hyper-intelligent child soldiers bred in laboratories. We'll begin by studying the original Stanley Parable. Here it is in its raw, untouched form, a specimen of technological perfection. Time to exploit it for profit. We begin by adding jokes. The Stanley Parable was most widely known for its stark lack of humor, bucking all conventional industry wisdom. It was a bold artist statement that its developers stood firmly behind. But in 2022, it's impossible to reach even a single consumer of video games without jokes of some kind. So very well, jokes it'll be. During its development, over 500 kiloliters of comedy will be funneled directly into the core of the Stanley Parable 2, creating jobs for hundreds of machine operators and producing 30,000 tons of pollutant chemical byproduct, which will be pumped directly into local lakes, rivers, and beautiful nature reserves like these all over the country.
Like a good
Another
company.
Another common complaint of the Stanley Parable is that there wasn't enough gameplay. And so for the sequel, its developers have gone to great lengths to fix this problem. Here we can see gameplay being printed onto sheets. Every video game contains as many as 1,000 sheets of gameplay. And several of the largest games ever made contain close to 1,500. On mobile devices, the gameplay sheets have to be printed smaller. For the Stanley Parable 2, as many as 35 new gameplay sheets
wow.
are being printed, each of which must be delicately massaged by the hands of a child before being added into the game.
Oh my
this
God.
Man is stealing gameplay sheets from the factory, which he likely intends to use for a personal project he's been developing in his spare time. A good public stoning will cure him of that inclination. Let's check on Gregory real quick. Still recovering from a hard day's work. Don't you move a muscle. Next up, it's time to blackmail the press. In a competitive market, blackmailing your local journalist can be one of the most effective methods of creating word-of-mouth buzz for your sequel. In fact, blackmail is the currency of social progress. From your neighborhood grocer to the teacher at your school to the man who helps you steal HBO, everyone responds to blackmail.
Is
and
that true, guys?
Before,
I should try
it's
that
easy
out.
Easy to practice at home on your friends and family.
Exactly.
Simply
I'm going to practice that on my friends.
That your teacher hands out after the end of the film. And finally, there's one last tool at our disposal for making the sequel feel fresh and exciting, and that's packaging the game with collector's edition merchandise.
Ooh-hoo-hoo.
If you order the Stanley Parable 2, you'll receive this cow's egg. A single egg will produce over 1,000 cows, which
Excuse me?
Of course, the sequel to pigs. And there you have it. Everything there is to know about producing the Stanley Parable 2. Of course, you may know that there is also a game titled The Stanley Parable Ultra Deluxe. So which game is the true sequel to the Stanley Parable? It's an excellent question, Billy. One which the child
Good job,
soldiers
Billy.
Have been working round the clock to come up with an answer to. And after many weeks of diligent research, the conclusion they've reached is, who gives a shit? All that matters is that it's more content for you to cram down your insatiable gullet. You don't want thoughtful and nuanced answers to complex questions, Billy. You just want to eat bubblegum and cheated hopscotch. So get out there and consume. Do your civic duty and bully your parents into buying you every version of the Stanley Parable 2 on every platform. Tell your friends to bully their parents as well. It's through community efforts like these that the world comes together.
Oh, that's beautiful.
And it's only through this connection that we'll defeat Time Dracula once and for all. Don't let the time-traveling vampires win. Buy the Stanley Parable 2.
Yeah, guys, come on.
All sequels for today, tomorrow, and into the great unknowable beyond.
That's beautiful. Ah, In Memoriam of Billy. Who only turned 3 years old? What the frick? Only turned 3 years old. No, poor Billy. Jesus Christ. Okay. Well, that was interesting. Alternate title, funny narrator man talks trash for 10 minutes. Absolutely. Didn't share a single selfie so I can track the metadata to the exact address. Oh, God. Oh, God. Okay. So we found that now. That was great. Let's see. Let's go to the reassurance bucket, guys. I want to know about the reassurance bucket.
A common complaint of the Stanley Parable was that it was confusing and paradoxical. That it engendered a chaotic sense of reckless despair in those who played it. Well, I'm happy to say that after much consideration, I've engineered a clever solution to this fundamental problem with the game. It's the Stanley Parable Reassurance Bucket.
There he comes, guys.
Stanley,
there he comes.
Anytime you're holding the bucket, a sense of calm and ease will fill your mind.
This is a major part of the game. Remember this? Okay, will do.
As long as you hold onto the bucket, the many disorienting contradictions of the Stanley Parable will feel perfectly normal and perhaps even comforting. You may even come to long for the gentle embrace of jarring cognitive dissonance while the bucket is in your arms. And to be honest, it's a much more convenient solution for me than actually redesigning the game to be less uncomfortable. Can you imagine what a pain in the ass that would be? Yes, the bucket is the perfect solution.
Come on, see.
Give it a try.
Give me that bucket.
Can you feel it? The glow of comfort, even in the face of crushing despair, must already be sweeping through your body. And in fact, can I say that I do believe the bucket lends you an air of charisma as well? I think that just holding it has made you the slightest bit more attractive as a person. The benefits of the bucket seem to go on, don't they? All this and more awaits you in the Stanley Parable 2.
Okay, well, I guess we're taking that bucket with us. What a nice reassurance bucket.
Does anyone give out awards for most enjoyable bucket in a video game? That really should be an award if it isn't already. Okay, I'll be honest, I haven't yet decided on this one. I think that in the new version, the office could use a bit of decoration, like balloons. But I'm undecided on Get Well Someday and Happy 12th Birthday. Which would you go with?
Get well someday, obviously.
You know, sometimes when you solicit another person's opinion, it makes you realize that you knew which one you actually really wanted all along.
No, goddammit!
Happy 12th birthday, step niece, it is.
No. Well, everything is decorated now. Great.
Actually, maybe I should have gone with... No. No, I've made my decision. We're moving on.
Let's see. Oh my god, the bucket comes. Oh, it's a jump circle! Wait, where do we come from? From here, right? So then... We look at this. Okay, I guess that's where we want to go now. Go to the jump circle.
You know what? Let's bring the jump circle back for Stanley Parable 2 as well.
Yes, please.
Oh, wait. You already spent all your jumps the first time we saw the jump circle. Oh, well. I suppose it can just be a nice decorative piece, then.
No, my jumping! It's not even that well done. Come on, look at that. Can't even jump. Please reassure me right now, Bucket, because I'm feeling quite sad. So we can go that way? Exit and collectibles. And a free new plus easy achievement. Yes! I can't believe it's that simple. Absolutely, that's for me. Free achievement. Get yours right now. Pull the lever, receive your new achievement. No more steps. It just works. Get yours right now. Pull the lever, Krunk.
Now, here's something special. You remember that broken test achievement that got left in the game on accident? Well, I'm developing a technology to simply give you the achievement. Yes. You see, you'll come to this lever, and when you pull it, the achievement will be given to you. It's as simple as that.
Oh, I want that...
Okay, perhaps I should have clarified. This is technology that will exist. Right now, the achievement is still fully broken. I'm not a wizard, Stanley. But I guarantee it will be fixed in the sequel. To at last satisfy the hordes of ravenous fans all over the world who have been uproariously demanding...
Amazing minds think alike, guys.
We hear you, and I promise it will happen.
God damn it, I feel cheated. I want that achievement. Come on. Look at that, it's like slightly opening, but it's not giving it to me. If you click it 427 times, you get the achievement. Wait, really? Is that true? Is that actually true? Does anyone, Chris, tell me, is that true? Is Potato lying to me right now? It's Potato, I don't know if I can trust you. I don't know if I can trust you. I really, really want that achievement. Sure, let's say it's true. I mean, this is prime content, isn't it? But that wouldn't make any sense. Why 427? Huh? Explain that to me, Spotato. Why would it be 427 times? Tell me that. What is the thought behind that? Oh, your employee. Yeah, that's true. Forgot about that. I want that achievement. How much was this? We're probably like 100 in already, right? It's not true. God damn it, Spotato. God damn it. And here I was trusting you. Never again. Never again, Spotato. Ugh. Didn't even get my achievement.
What other exhibits haven't we seen yet?
Something up here. Can you find them? Can you find them? Can you find them? Collect them all. Ooh.
Ah, collectibles. Now it's a real video game. In the Stanley Parable 2, you'll run around gathering up these miniature Stanley figurines. And what's truly innovative is that there will be no reward for collecting all of them. I don't want to stifle the intrinsic joy of watching a number go up. You simply collect all of them, and then you move the hell on with your unremarkable life.
Why is it all so sad? Nice! 1 out of 6! Now what? That was it? Now what? 1 out of 6? God, you were doing a little trolling! You are not being forgiven!
And then they give you a big fancy reward for it. Absolutely tragic.
Exit is closed. We can go that way. Let's go to the infinite hole first. It won't end. That sounds amazing. Just what I need right now. That was the content I came here to see! I thought I was the content you came here to see, Gems. Okay, excuse me. Whole entrance, infinity. Makes sense. Yeah, I get that. I truly, truly get that so well. Now, there it is.
Stanley, here's an idea that I'm truly fond of. It's never been done before in a video game. This is, in fact, a hole that you can fall down forever. That's right. Infinite falling. You can fall until the end of time, if you like. A stunning leap forward for video games as a medium.
Your brother got the iPad? Oh, sorry for that, guys. I was staring at your face. You all know that I do the same, Gems. Like, staring at your face, not my face. Let's be clear about that. I do the same. Potato tells you the hole actually has an end. You should totally believe that. I don't know what to think about that, Chris. I know I should never believe you anymore. You have completely earned my distrust. So, this your favorite one? Should we try this at the end? Should we? Zuko, yeah. Should I not do this one yet? Should I? You heard Aslan bark and answered him. They're already having this special connection, Gems. Do this now if you want, okay? Geronimo!
You see, isn't it wonderful? One of my more ingenious concoctions, if I do say so. Now then, since you've gotten to see the infinite hole, you can press the teleport button to pop back up to the top, and we can continue onward.
So how is he guys' day?
Now,
huh?
I don't mean to be a bummer, but I do recommend you use the teleport button to go back to the top. Maybe do it on the sooner rather than later spectrum of things.
No, thank you. Just chilling. Yeah, me too, Gems. Me too. Nothing special going
thank
on today,
Stanley.
To be honest.
I don't know quite how to
especially
say this
not tonight.
But it's possible that I slightly exaggerated the infinite nature of the hole. Is it a very, very deep hole? To be certain it is. It's an extremely deep hole. I don't want anyone to say that it isn't an astonishingly deep hole. It is. Is it infinite? Well, that sort of depends on your definition of infinity. From one perspective, the infinite is merely philosophical in nature. It's more of a... Okay, well, good for you. You found the bottom of the hole. You found me out, Stanley. I'm a liar and a cheat, and you're so clever.
Woohoo!
Look, I think the issue here is just that you're unusually fascinated by falling. What normal person actually wants to fall infinitely? I figured the hole was as deep as anyone would actually need. Don't you put this on me. Maybe you're the problem.
Exactly. I understand that. Blame everyone else.
Things got a little heated there. I think we both said some things we didn't mean. Why don't we just put all this behind us and agree to just call the hole mostly infinite? If that works for you, then go ahead and press the teleport button to warp up to the top of the hole and we can move on. I'll just be up here when you're ready.
Is almost similar to our Dark Souls stream? Wait! You mean because I constantly battle with gravity? What do you mean, Goku? Go down the hole again after this? Can I? Okay. You didn't like... That's actually true. I trust you now over Chris.
Great. Now, I'm very excited to show you even more of my ideas for the sequel. Oh,
woohoo!
Heaven. You see, I was right. The problem is you. The problem is that you like holes too much. Not normal. A normal person would have said, yep, that's an infinite hole right there. Goes on forever till the end of time. Don't need to see it all, but not you. Oh, no. You have a weird sort of... Oh. Did the hole seem even shorter to you this time?
Yeah,
it
did.
I couldn't help but feel like you spent a little less time in
absolutely.
There than you did before. I mean, admittedly, I didn't make an infinite hole, but I didn't think it was that not infinite. Well, I suppose once again there's nothing to do here. If you decide you've had enough of the hole, you can hit the teleport button and come join me up above. Had enough? I'm positively thrilled. I really do have so much more to show you and to talk about, and I've had enough of the hole for a lifetime.
Let's go!
Gosh, how could I have guessed? You're back in the hole. If this starts to become a thing where... Wow. Okay, yes. I'm starting to become extremely certain that the hole is not only not infinite, but that it's growing steadily less and less infinite.
Mm-hmm.
I suspect that I'm starting to hit the point where it's no longer feasible to call the hole infinitely deep, even by the lax overall standards for accountability and marketing. What's going on here? Stanley, I have no explanation for the uncertain nature of the hole's length. Here, let's try something. Let's pop back up to the top, and we'll see if it gets any shorter. Well, there it is. The shame of my lie has come to haunt me. Not only is the hole not infinite, but it's barely even a hole at this point. It's more of a concavity, or even a very aggressive divot.
Let's go in.
Is this still appealing to you? I know you're obsessed with holes, but at this depth, I just can't see this scratching the itch.
It doesn't. Oh, it doesn't.
Who am I to judge? You just do whatever it is you're here to do and hit the teleport button when you're ready to move on.
It doesn't work.
Is the teleport button
It doesn't work. Levels, sure? Yes?
Well, I mean...
Oh, my,
I
indeed.
I didn't have an explanation. It was working just a moment ago. Try it again.
Nope.
Still nothing. Well, I suppose there is one thing I can do to fix this. I'm out. Goodbye, Stanley. You couldn't bear to be away from the hole, and now you'll get more time with it than you could ever have asked for. It's a win for everyone. You get to be with the hole, I get to do literally anything else. Take care, Stanley.
That is a win-win.
I hope you and the hole have a wonderful rest of eternity.
Why did you trust me? I was the one who told you to trust Potato. One word. Jump scares are us. That's all. Didn't know you swung that way. Isn't that what most mammals do? So now what? We're just stuck in here, guys. We're just stuck in here. What is happening? The hole's getting deeper. The hole's getting deeper again. The hole's getting deeper again. Woo! Is it becoming an infinite hole now? Only for Jems! Jems! You're making me blush there. You're making me blush there. You understand. Change your perspective? Oh, look at that. Wait, do we have two buckets now? No, it's just one bucket. It was a shadow. Oh my god. That is a perspective. Change your perception. I wonder what they're saying. It's clearly a turnaround, right? I just wanted to get the first song again. It's the crows, crows, crows! Jesus Christ. Are we getting all the way around? It's just getting weirder and weirder. How many is there? Oh, it's rain. That's nice. That's great. I might want to stick with this one. Thomas! Hi, how are you doing? Happy to see you! This is all the kind of music I like. Aphex Twin type beats. You just returned from your exam? Oh yeah, that was a Monday! How did it go? Oh wait, are we around? You can't get the funk song again? We'll look for atmospheric sound. Oh, that's a shame. It's fine. Oh wait. Not the birds. Not that one. Wait. I'm sorry, Spotato, I'm sorry. Sure, let's go with the rain. Okay. Change reality. Oh man. Yeah, that's good. I like the red. Can we get back to the red? Change yourself. Oh god. To what? Can we get the red, please? There we go. Ah! 4 to 7. Where are we now? Oh man, yeah. Oh! Oh yeah, even better! Okay, wait, we gotta go back to the... There we go. Now what? Change perspective, there's puppies.
Stanley?
Oh!
Stanley! Stanley!
Ah!
Oh good, you're awake. It seems you have some dazed off there, drifting away into dreamland. But we can't.
Sorry, guys. Saw it too late.
This hole is just so darn fascinating that I want you to be wide awake for every second of it. You don't want to miss a single moment. So how about if I just pop in from time to time and wake you up to keep you really, truly focused on the hole? From the looks of things, you and I will have many, many years here in this hole, and I'm looking forward to all of them. Stay alert, Stanley. I'll be back. Toodlepip.
I'll be back. Again. Can we do that again? That was great! Are we doing it again? Sounds like we're doing it again. Oh, no. Ah! Again! Toodlepip!
Here we are. Go on. Try out some of the new features.
Okay, now... We did the hole. But I guess the only way that we can still go is this way, right? Go up? I think? There's a lot of mugs on the wall.
Alright, have you seen everything you wanted to? Ready to move on now?
I have to try a screenshot? Which button is screenshot again? 11? F11? I think we weren't allowed to make a screenshot in the room here, right? Here? I think this is where he mentioned it. Yeah, no screenshots. Oh, F12. Okay. Oh, it's not. Both don't work. doesn't work. It doesn't work. I tried. You aren't on Steam? No, I am. There you go, I am. Oh, you guys can't see that, but I have the Steam thing up. Button? Oh, that does nothing. I mean, even when I open Steam, it says to press F12 while in-game to take a screenshot, but... I can't! I'm sorry, guys. Not able to. It says I need to press F12, but it's not working. Does that thing turn with me? Or is that just me? Oh, it does turn. Oh, that's creepy. Doesn't turn with me, though, but it does turn. You can't run, unfortunately. Let's make the slow way up the stairs again. See what we find at the top. I'm so surprised with how much content there still was, guys. Like, holy moly. I did not see that coming. New mug.
So, Stanley, what do you think? Do you like all of the new features? Yes, I know it's not exactly clear yet how exactly these features will come together as one single coherent video game, but I can feel it in my soul. It's going to work. There's definitely a good game in there somewhere. Say, let's do an experiment. I'll arrange these new features together, and we'll see whether or not it coheres into a meaningful gameplay experience. Okay, are you ready? Here it is. I give you the Stanley Parable 2. I mean, there's potential here, right? It's sort of... Okay, never mind. Hold on, let me do a different arrangement. Okay, yes, this is much better. I feel good about this. Here we go. Version 2. Who am I kidding, Stanley? This isn't a coherent video game at all. It's a lot of gags. And I do very much enjoy creating gags, but they don't add up to anything. I wanted more than anything to create a sequel that would capture all the magic of the first game. I wanted fans to love it. No matter how good these gags are, they won't stand on their own. They would need the structure and the gameplay of the original. Wait, maybe that's it. I can take the original Stanley Parable and simply, well, insert a few of my new features into it. Tastefully, of course. With respect. With care for the vision and integrity of the original game. Would it possibly work? I suppose it could. But it would need a really, really tremendous title screen. A title screen that says with bold and uncompromising conviction, "This is the Stanley Parable 2. Let me see if I can whip something up. All right, perfect. Go ahead. Take a look.
Oh. Okay. Wait, really? It put the infinite hole inside the jump circle. I didn't even see that. That's great. I didn't even see that. You haven't even started the Stanley Parable 2 yet? This is actually going to be a thing? You've seen nothing yet? Wait, guys, how long is this gonna take? Should we do this now or next stream? How much content is there still left for us? Because we can also end now. Start next stream? Okay, I think that's better then. Is it just gonna start here next time I start the game? Now it's potato, but I need basically double... Okay. No, then we're definitely gonna do it next stream. Because I need some food sometime soon. It will start here? Okay, awesome. Or just never end stream. But the end is never the end, is never the end, is never the end, is never the end, Thomas. Did you not know that? The end is never the end, is never the end, is never the end, is never the end. Wait, there we go. Then we gotta go put some music on. There we go. End is not end. There we go. It's me, Cheshire. Will we get to set our favorite time first? Yeah, that's hopefully what we get to do next time. I hope so. Oh, it's Potato. Thank you so much for the follow. I really appreciate it. That's so sweet of you. Thank you so much. See why it was so eager for you to do new content now? Yeah, I see. But I'm happy that we did, hopefully, most of the stuff first before we got here. I'm really happy about that. But yeah, this game is so much longer than I thought it was. I seriously thought last stream that we ended it very quickly on already. The beginning is the end and the end is the beginning. Infinite streamer chest is in an infinite hole. I mean, for sure, by far, the best part of it so far was the infinite hole. Love that part. Well, let's see who we're gonna raid, guys. Let's see who we're gonna raid. We could raid Silver. I feel like I don't often have the option to raid Silver. Should we do that? I feel like we should do that. Playing some Sniper Elite 5. Maybe not my type of game, but in the next 12-hour stream, we should spend 4 hours trying to click that button. But muted? Maybe? Possibly? I prefer the button that says your name. Yeah. As a gym, I felt very spoken to in that one, I have to admit. So those are the looks add so much to the game. So this is all new, right? I thought it was really just that I didn't know they actually made so much new content with Ultra Deluxe. I was thought it was kind of like a remake with a little bit extra edit, but make sure they're still alive. Shush! Shush, Grace, shush! But yeah. We're going to be doing that very soon. Let me see. Rating, I mean. Let me see for a second. By the way, Phoenix was so sweet as to give me the Trolley Problem Incorporated. Never heard of that before. But I think there's a way to interact with stream, if I understood that correctly, but I haven't looked into it yet. But yeah, so probably we're going to play that sometime soon as well in our Monday slot. Maybe after we finish the Stanley Parable, I'm not sure yet, or we're gonna play not Firewatch, what's the name? Journey, that's the name. But yeah, we still have many games to play in this option. Also, I don't know, I'll hold a poll about it as well. But I was thinking, originally I wanted to play Red Dead Redemption 2 on YouTube, but I was thinking maybe it's more of a Twitch game. In my mind, it's a little bit similar gameplay-wise as to Horizon Zero Dawn. So I feel like that could be great for stream, maybe. What do you guys think? Do you have any opinions on that? Trolley Problem Incorporated is going to be so good on stream. Okay. Oh, I'm so happy to hear that. Yeah. It's there now. It's added to the list. We're going to play that sometime soon. Got to finish the Stanley Parable first. But yeah, it's on the list now. I'm very excited about it. Thank you so much again, Phoenix. And that you're around for it. I hope so too. I'll post an announcement in Discord once we're going to do it. Red Dead on stream sounds fun. Yeah, I figured maybe that could be our next big game. I don't know yet about our next big game, guys. I don't really have anything in mind, to be honest. I can't play Horizon Forbidden West since I don't have a PlayStation 5. I can't play Bloodborne or Demon's Souls because of PlayStation. But yeah, our next big game might have to be Red Dead Redemption 2, and then we're gonna do that on stream instead. Unless you guys have any other suggestions, but time to go back to the big old list you have. Yeah, but the problem is most of the games on that list are for YouTube, to be honest. Like, I'm not gonna play, for example, Bioshock or Dishonored on stream because I already started that on YouTube. God of War. Would that be a good game for YouTube or for stream? Guild Wars 2. I mean, I'm open for playing Guild Wars 2, but I just don't feel like that would be any interesting for you guys to watch. That might only be interesting for people that know the game, but for people that don't know the game, I don't even start off like at the beginning of the game and we explore together. I just start off in the middle. What about Dishonored Killing Everyone run? or a no-kill run. Yeah, I definitely am planning to do those things, but it's not really like the next big game slot, you know? It's more of a side thing, I feel. You play Guild Wars 2, I can see what the game looks like with a decent frame rate. And long loading screens, though, since I don't have an SSD to put it on. More of Cheshire Strange that you can play old games. Yeah, but I need to know what, though. I need a suggestion for a game to play, guys. Because let me take a look at my list. Because I don't remember from the top of my head to have another option in there that's really that good for a stream. Problem with long games on YouTube is that most people only watch the first 5 episodes and the last one. Yeah, I agree. So that's why I thought... Because I think Red Dead Redemption is a really long game, right? Let me open my 2 playlist. Did you guys hear that Silk Song is gonna come out somewhere in the next year? Did you guys hear that? It's gonna come out on Game Pass? Did you guys know? Because, oh my god, I just found out today. I'm crazy excited for that one. Seriously, crazy excited. I do think I'm gonna play that one on YouTube, though. But we'll see. I'm not sure about that yet. But let's... Oh, Sekiro! We, of course, still have Sekiro to play. Okay, then I'll hold a poll, seeing if we want to play Sekiro or Red Dead Redemption 2 next. Because we still, of course, have a little bit to go for Dark Souls 3, but I do feel like we're, you know, starting to make some progress in that game. So it's good to already have a next game in mind for after that. Sekiro will be fun. I'm very scared for that game. Very scared, but... I'm so happy it's on Game Pass, it's free for me. That's freaking amazing to hear, Ados. That's amazing to hear. Also, Stray is coming out very soon, right? I think Stray is coming out very, very soon. Let's see what other games we have. Oh yeah, Control. Would Control be good for on stream, maybe? We can keep the death counter going with Sekiro. Yay. Great, that's so nice. Wait, let me make sure... That Silver is still streaming, by the way. Control would be a good stream game? Okay, that's good to hear. So we have some options. What was that game you said? One Stop that makes change to the computer? No, One Shot. Freaking amazing game. Honestly, I love it so much. I don't want to spoil too much, because that game is really best played blind. Like, already for people that want to play it, I feel like I spoiled too much now. But yeah. It's short enough it will work on YouTube. Okay, I'll see about that. But for sure, we have Sekiro and Red Dead Redemption 2 as options now. And Control for YouTube. Okay, I see. I'm gonna let you guys pick between those two. I'll put a poll up on Discord and you guys can pick. I'll see what other options we have. And if you guys have any suggestions, please feel free to let me know. You can just put it in the suggestion channel, send it to me, whatever you want. But yeah. We need to find a new game for after Dark Souls 3, so... But, guys, we are going to be raiding Silver. Oh yeah, Assassin's Creed Odyssey is also a really good option. You're right, Adas. That's also a really good option. Okay, I'll add that to the list as well. So that's at least 3 options that we have already. But yeah, we're going to be raiding Silver. Freaking amazing guy. Good friend of Mike's as well. So I see Mike's is in chat there instead of here. Cheater. Little cheater that he is. But yeah, please go show him some love. Really, really nice guy. Honestly, guys. Also, I have a YouTube channel for people who don't know yet. I play Elden Ring on there at the moment, as well as Dishonored. Actually, Dishonored just finished. I gotta think now. I recorded a few videos already for the first DLC, The Knife of Dunwall, I think it's called, if I remember correctly. But yeah, I recorded a few videos for that already. But also, I'm kind of debating if I should play Bioshock 2 first before releasing videos of the DLC, just to kind of switch things up again, because we have been playing the same games for a while on YouTube now. But yeah, I'm not sure yet. There's a lot of decisions I need to make, and I don't really, know yet what decisions are the right decisions, basically. Also, I have a second YouTube channel on which I post all my old Twitch VODs. I've been working on putting the 12-hour stream on there, the second 12-hour stream. Some more Dark Souls will be coming soon. The Stanley Parable, is uploading at the moment. Just gotta finish that up. So yeah, those things will be on there very soon as well. So yeah, feel free to check that out as well. And lastly, we have a Discord server, guys, which is filled with all these wonderful and amazing people. Plus, you can get rich if you join. I swear, it's not a scam. It's true. Go check it out. And once you join, you can't leave. I mean, go check it out, please. By the way, I released my first short film on YouTube. And I will probably share it on Discord, so join the Discord. Yes, please share that, Goku. I would love to see that. Oh, I would love to see that. Please share that in Discord. I really, really want to see that. I can't wait. That's really, really exciting. Okay, I'm very curious to see what's going to be about. But yeah, guys, thank you so much for being here. I had a freaking amazing time having you all here, as usual. This game is so much fun. I honestly love this game so much. not a cult. Yeah, we still have another cult rule that we need to come up with. I watch all the Portal vids during the weekend again. Can't recommend. That's so sweet, Peter. What the frick? That's so freaking sweet of you. Thank you so much. That's really, really sweet. I'll try to die more. I'm sorry. but yeah, hopefully I will see you all on Wednesday with some more Dark Souls 3, which I'm very excited for. I will be starting the stream at 5 Central European Summertime. There we go. Oh my god, it's always difficult. hopefully, I will see you guys then. Thank you guys so much for being here tonight. I had such a good time. I hope you guys did too. Hopefully, I will see you all on Wednesday. In the meantime, I hope you guys have a lovely rest of the day. A good night, a great night's sleep, and a good few days until I see you on Wednesday.